You are now listening to the Inner Circle Podcast Network.
Hashtag no offense uses strong language and is intended for a mature audience. Listener discretion is advised. Hashtag no offense.
All right, Gandalf, you sent me some music. You want to come in?
Yeah. Do I need to record anything?
Come on, Jodie. You kick your feet up. You relax. Everything's good, baby. Just enjoy the ride.
Just for fucking internet's sake and all that bullshit, I wanted to make sure I didn't leave you hanging.
Some honky tonk shit tonight.
Chris Stapleton's amazing.
Welcome back to another episode of the Hashtag No Offense Show. My name is Chris, joined by my lovely wife, the Duchess.
Hello.
And you know, if we're rocking something called Arkansas, there must be only one motherfucker in the house, and that's that motherfucker, Jody B.
Oh man, this makes me feel so good.
Chris Stapleton is one of the only new country artists that I can get down with.
You like Zach Rock Band? Or
I do. I do. And see, but I'm not supposed to. I'm not supposed to like Zach Brown. That's not cool. You ain't supposed to like Zach Brown.
Look, Zach Brown is fine. I enjoy Zach Brown too. So does my wife. There's a few of those people that are trying to keep people interested in country music, and I appreciate the Zach Browns and the Chris Stapletons. I don't like the new. Where they use the fake music and stuff. I like instruments and stuff.
Yeah, go figure. Go figure. You like instruments in your songs.
Yeah, I mean, call me crazy, but I feel like it's necessary. And yeah, a lot of the new stuff uses a lot of electronically produced. I sent you a whole ass video about it. It was talking about snap tracks. It's interesting as shit, but it's taken over the country genre now, and I can't do it. Like, if I hear a doom, 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 dude, it's all produced and it sucks. Like, it turns me off immediately. I won't even listen to it. I'll turn the shit off.
I hear you, dude. I'm with you. And normally I don't get exposed to it anymore because ever since I got myself a new truck, she doesn't drive anymore and that shit doesn't roll in my vehicle. But when we're in hers, it's like fucking Y2 country for life. Like, she's all about that shit, dude.
I listen to everything. I listen to everything.
Brooks and Dunn. Did he tell you that saga? The Brooks and Dunn incident where he told me he was like, fuck Brooks and Dunn, blah, blah, blah. And I just harassed him.
I stand by it. Ronnie Dunn's a fucking cancer patient and kicks Brooks as a child molester, dude. Fuck them. Fuck them both, dude.
Listen, I can't defend his mustache, but I can defend Ronnie Dunn's voice. He's got the voice of an angel.
He does not. He looks like if Macaulay Culkin like came out retarded.
God damn!
That's Ronnie Dunn.
My goodness.
It's not okay.
I mean, you know what? You're wearing a shit happens when you party naked shirt. I'm wearing a shit happens when you party naked shirt. So within the first couple of seconds, we got to say retarded. We got it out of the way. The table is set. We got Jody B here. Jody B for his annual January kickoff the year appearance, it seems like. You come by every January and we talk some shit.
I love it. Thank you for having me. I know. I'm sorry it takes so long. The bad news is, guys, I haven't been up to any drama or shenanigans or anything this time, so we just get to talk this time. I don't have to, you know, talk anybody off a ledge or explain myself. We're just hanging out tonight, baby.
I'm calling your bluff, for one. You ain't been up to no goddamn shenanigans. I can see right through that shit-eating grin you got hiding behind that pop filter right there, sir. We'll get to it, though. We'll get to it. I know you cracked a drink, and we don't have one yet, but you got something in store. You got the Dutch going to play bartender tonight, but before we do that, I want to shout out some sponsors so I can pay my bills.
You gonna hit him with that extra man?
With the hoota hoota?
You gonna hit him with that extra man?
You're gonna have to explain that, dude.
Are you serious?
Are you dropping wrestling isms on me? Because that feels like a wrestling ism.
It's your Hemp Bombs sound effect, you fuck.
Oh, the extra man, like the one up. Riley, raise some money for me. This episode and every episode of the Hashtag No Offense Show sponsored by Hemp Bomb CBD. There it is. I'm going to pipe that in later. Hemp Bombs are specifically formulated to provide consumers with a quality CBD product at an affordable price. Many benefits of Hemp Bombs include a reduced anxiety, increased sense of relaxation, reduction of aches and pains, mood enhancement, and deep and restful sleep. Hemp Bombs come in a wide variety of different products, including oils, gummy suckers, vapes, and even products for your pet. Use code HTNOS at HempBombs.com. Save 20% on your entire order. And chill the fuck out. And chill the fuck out. It's a new year. It's a new day.
Yup.
Ha. We are also sponsored by Onnit.com. Onnit is a health and fitness juggernaut dedicated to delivering complete and total human optimization. The wide array of products and supplements, Onnit combines cutting-edge science, earth-grown nutrients, and time-tested strategies to help people reach their peak performance. They got the Alpha Brain. They got the New Mood. They got the Shroom Tech. My baby likes the gut health. It makes her tummy feel good. when she goes out and she makes me day drink and we eat too much and we have two dinners instead of one dinner because she's feeling like she's on vacation and it's really only 2 hours before we have to go pick up the kids.
I told you, anytime I'm not with the children, I'm on vacation.
That is,
I can respect that.
That is amazing and horrible all rolled into one. And I think that's you, baby.
According to our one-star review, that is me. So
you get where you fit in. Don't worry about him.
That's right.
Visit Onnit.com. Use code HTNOS. Save 10% on whatever you choose to make yourself a better version of yourself.
Word.
Now, I am parched, so I need to wet this whistle. Jody B., tell me what we got to do here.
So here's the thing, guys. During this whole corona madness, everything over the summertime, I picked up some new habits and hobbies. And this is one that actually my buddy showed me from off of the Facebook. You know, I don't Facebook myself. So this is a mixed drink we're going to use just because out of respect. I know that there are certain other fans of the show that listen. We don't want to have to show any disrespect or loyalty brands. So we're going to refer to this beer. We're going to call this beer a COVID. It's a bottle of COVID.
Bottle of COVID. Nice. I can dig it.
I got to say, I was kind of nervous about your drink since you go to the Church of Latter-day Saints. So
I was like, got him.
Listen, I pray at the altar every Sunday, goddammit. Hashtag
mess. I just popped this like a foot away from my face and I just smell it. You know, we used to say that like they piss in the bottle because they're never level.
Yeah, that COVID beer is very skunky. I'm not a huge fan of it, and that's why I wanted to share, because I assumed you guys probably don't drink them. You're not 23 anymore, so nope. It's not really something you get into.
This is going to be, I kid you not, swear my life, my first Corona ever. Never drink this shit.
Whoa. COVID beer.
COVID whatever. Bottle. COVID beer.
It's been a long day. She dropped the cues.
Listen.
Okay, all right, so look, do I gotta drink the neck out of this or something? What do I got to do here? Absolutely.
Well, you get your little, get your pet there. Good luck, health, and loyalty, and all that shit. Get you a sip down to about the bottom of that neck of that bottle. Yeah.
Drink both of them.
This is a good sip. You want a good drink out of the top of that. Get it down to the neck.
Mm-hmm.
All right,
Jemai.
Mm-hmm. You can go a little further than that, Dutch, if you can.
I'm making him do it.
Mm-hmm.
She ain't trying to do it.
That's perfect. You nailed it, dude. Right there, lunchbox. All right.
I don't do many things good, but I do drinking, all right.
Hey, look, we're going to call this a COVID sunrise. So what you're going to do now is you're going to take a bottle of your finest tequila, whatever you had purchased. I don't know what he spent money on there, so hopefully it was something nice.
I got some Camarina.
Ooh, I use 1800, just a little $10 bottle. You don't have to be special. Just use something silver and not like just regular ass Jose Cuervo or Juarez or something. You want something a little better.
The girl that I sit next to brought this in when we were making drinks at work, and I really liked it because – yeah. It's hard to find a good tequila that has, it's, you know, not too expensive. So this is a good middle tequila.
Shout out to that fat ass bottle of tequila, bro.
Well, hey, we go through it in this house. I mean, she is the margarita queen.
How much?
You're going to get probably about a half a shot. You only want that to go up. All right, a little bit more. A little bit more. Yeah.
I like
there you go, right there.
I like the beautiful, way it runs beautiful down that bottle.
It's good, man. This is going to be great. You're going to put it probably, like I said, it's not a whole shot. About 3/4 of a shot is what you want in there. 1/2 to 3/4. There you go. Yeah. Like hit your line.
We got all that ambiance there. That click, 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 click.
I bet that blow your fucking mind. All right. Now hit your lime in there. You want to give it, just poke him down in there.
Did you cut him skinny enough?
Yeah. I'd get him pretty skinny. I can't stuff a whole 1/4 of a lime in my bottle. I'm a bitch like that.
Ooh-wee.
So there's one. Do the second one.
They're going to do your orange juice. Probably OJ, just up to about, I don't know, your first pinky knuckle into the neck of that bottle.
Good old Publix brand orange juice. No pulp.
We got the Poboys.
If I want to fucking chew an orange.
Are you breaking up there, Jody?
He said if he wanted to chew an orange, he'd buy one. All right. So last stop on this Corona train.
COVID.
Bottle COVID here.
It's Corona 19.
Just a little bit of grenadine. Shit, hold on. We're having some issues with that audio there, Jody.
It looks pretty.
Now from there, you can just drink that. But like I was telling Wesley earlier, you kind of want to do just so it mixes. You put your thumb on the bottle.
Oh, yeah.
Give it a little tip. Don't shake it. Turn it upside down. Turn it out nice and easy.
Just to like mix it up.
Hold on. Jody, do your trick on the internet real quick.
What's happening?
Oh, shit.
I squirted it.
It did squirt. We got a squirter.
Remember I told you, Wesley? You got to go kind of half your thumb meat. You got to burp that bottle. You don't just take your thumb off. I tell you what, Chris. Ooh,
She did it. That one was perfect.
And the lime came up in the neck.
That one was perfect. Well, the first one, I didn't tell you. I was trying to fix the audio discrepancies we were having here, so I didn't watch you on the first one. But the second one, I had eyes on you.
Okay, good.
All right, now this is a very beautiful concoction you got here. Let's see how it tastes. Dutchy poo-poo.
Cheers.
Listen, yeah, Dutch it up, guys. I appreciate you guys having me and sharing in the wealth here. Mm.
It's drinkable.
That is, yeah, it definitely dresses up the natural,
this needs non to be good.
Well, it does need to be colder, but it's been sitting here for 30 minutes, Jody.
Sorry.
But
it's, I understand it's hot in Florida. I'll mail you some ice if you need that, dickhead.
It's typically not my favorite beer, but it does dress it up nicely. And yeah, being that you are a car carrying member of the Church of Natter-day Saints, it does make sense that you like this because of the color and the sweetness. I mean, it's
absolutely,
it definitely fits the profile.
There's more sugar in that one, though. There's obviously, but there's more booze in that too, so you wouldn't drink as many. That's the other good thing.
Holy shit.
Two or three of those guys.
I forgot about the shot of tequila in there.
Yeah, you can't taste it.
Can't taste that shit
at
all.
That's why it's good tequila.
Can't taste that shit, not one little bit. I forgot that was in there. I thought we just put some juice and some fucking Shirley Temple mix in there, dude.
Nope, and that's the whole thing. Don't forget about that one. That one will sneak up on you. That's a bad bitch.
That's what we should call. That would make mad.
Well, Dutch kind of alluded to it in the beginning a little bit. Did you want to talk about your new fan at all? I wasn't going to bring it up, but since you already mentioned it.
Oh, we got a 1-star review that says I was terrible. Are you interested in being a co-host?
She got her... in all of her time, all I've heard is, oh my God, the Duchess is the best. She's so wrong. Yeah. She's so great.
I love it.
And then finally somebody was like, she's the fucking worst.
She needs to be replaced.
Called her, said she was racist, was misinformed, yeah. Fucking all kinds of shit. I was shocked.
Oh,
he was shocked, but then he was happy on the inside because he was like, finally, it's not.
Nah, he shit on me. Whoever it was shit on me too. But
said you got heart.
But I miss most of the time, which I mean, kind of accurate, you know. But
guys, the big picture. Look, the big picture is somebody. You guys move somebody enough emotionally that they felt the need to go sit at their computer or pull their phone out while they were shitting, whatever they were doing, but right. Enough to leave a review to tell them how you made them feel. So you know, good or bad, I guess.
Yeah, it didn't bother me. The only thing that kind of hit me for a loop was I couldn't remember the
context.
The content that they were referring to. They said Duchess said some racist shit, and I was like, I don't recall that.
Yeah, probably.
The title of the review was Killing Immigrants or Kill Immigrants.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, whatever. You know, it is what it is.
Is what it is.
Dutchie's a savage, bro. If you can't handle it, don't listen. Fuck you.
So
thanks for the review, though, I guess.
Yeah. Drive that 1-star bar up, baby. We need to even that out a little bit.
There you go.
I love that Gandalf pipe, by the way. That's the shit.
Oh, thank you.
That's the fucking shit. You're smoking that fucking Shire pipe.
I tell you what, my wife went and got some weed from the store yesterday. It's called Gunslinger. I don't know what's going to happen tonight. We're going to have a good time.
Gonna be slinging that gun, player. when we were at the store picking up our supplies for tonight, we had to get some lottery tickets, dude. You know our Mega Millions here is up to over a billion with a B tonight.
Yeah, it's our Mega Millions too, fuckhead. Like
it's over,
you know,
like
it's yours
states.
Too.
It's like over five states.
It's everybody.
Oh mm-hmm. Shit! Well, when I win it tonight, I'll make sure and hook you up, dude. I got plans.
I would love it.
I got fucking plans for that money.
All I need is like $1-2 million. I'll be fine, buddy. Like, you ain't gonna, we could hang out all week. We could podcast.
What are you
like
gonna do? Duchess,
you can hang out with my wife. I'm sure y'all will get along.
Sweet.
See, well, I told her, I'm gonna build a brick and mortar inner circle building down here. Like, we're gonna have like a thing with the logo on the front and some strip plaza somewhere. And we're just gonna go there and we're gonna smoke out and we're gonna have drinks and we're just gonna sit there and be creative. And that's gonna be our 9 to 5. We're gonna wake up in the morning, have a cup of coffee, go to work. You know, which will entail me moving all of my people, you know, locally, because at that point, you know, y'all all be employees anyway. You'd be on the fucking payroll, so you have no choice, right? Fucking
like a whole ass, like Rob Dyrdek, just fucking bringing in your friends to hang out in your factory where we just do dumb shit.
Yeah, fuck yeah, dude.
I like that.
That's what I'm going to do. When I give you that 1 to 2 that you're asking for, what are you going to do with it?
I'm going to start a show called What's Dickolessness. I don't want to let you guys watch videos. That's going to be fun.
Well, go ahead. You're going to say the same thing I was.
My brother was on that show when he did backyard wrestling clips. And what's the guy that was in Scream?
David Arquette.
David Arquette was one of the co-hosts on there. And, you know, he was in the Royal Rumble. Is that what it's called?
Ready to Rumble.
So they were doing all these.
He's done a bunch of stuff. Yeah, yeah.
He was in all these. He did backyard wrestling. So he was one of the clips that they played. Do you want to show him Nipple Ripper?
I don't know. Who did we show that?
It's one of my brother's videos that's on the internet. They did extreme juggalo wrestling. Him and his buddies. Nice. Because they were all into, well, they still are into ICP.
Talk amongst yourselves. I'll pull it up.
If Dude. You
who did we show that to?
Was
once
it
before?
Delvin?
It might have been Delvin. We showed it to somebody.
I think it was Delvin. But
Dutch, you think people still do that? Like, surely people don't still backyard wrestle. Oh, that's
sure
not a
they
thing.
Do.
No, not like it was back in the day when we were kids. Like, we didn't have all that internet business and we were fucking wiling out, man. I didn't do it myself personally because it looked like it hurt a little bit, but.
Oh, it totally hurt. You'll see.
All right, here you go.
They'd find mattresses in the alley and just take them for their, you know, their stuff.
Well, you're a wrestler fan too, so you probably appreciate it.
Yeah, this is top tier, like early 2000s, maybe even 1999.
That the gentleman that's being carried up right now is my brother-in-law.
One more step.
Yeah. Oh, man.
They have fluorescent light bulbs on the plywood.
The slow motion effect.
That was my mom's backyard.
Damn, what's doing so bad, huh? Oh, your nipple.
Oh, he's leaking.
I got his nipple! Yeah! Oh, my God!
That's my brother.
Good. That man's got a family. Can you believe the carnage?
Now he does. He didn't back then. He didn't even have health insurance. He was jumping off the fucking roof and shit.
Hey, got his ass on the MTV for a hot second.
That's true.
Dutch, how does that nipple hold up? Does he still got it? Slice it in half?
That's what I was telling him. They ripped his nipple off because it's called Nipple Ripper. And he was like, no, it just got cut.
Oh, yeah. He was back. I published that on Sunday. And I think Monday morning he was in her text messages going, my nipple didn't get ripped off. I still got it.
Oh, I was going to ask. I've got 3 of them. I was going to say, if he needs a nipple donated, I got one for him. Yeah, I'll happily share.
Nipple transplant. Dude, we're changing lives out here. He's like a Make-A-Wish kid.
I'm sure there's some out-of-work fucking plastic surgeon down there in your neck of the woods that's just bored. And he's like, yeah, I'll take a nipple off one fat guy and put it on another guy. Well, that's fine.
I'm sure there's a out-of-work plastic surgeon.
I wouldn't know.
Oh, man. So you just hold on. Now I want to let this breathe for a second, guys. Do you think there are people that get like plastic surgery, like extra nipples put on?
I mean,
like cosmetic.
There has to be a thing, right? Like cosmetic nipples, where you get like if you're a furry or you're into whatever, like you get like 6 or 7 nipples down your fucking. That'd be crazy.
I want to say I feel like I remember seeing someone had that tattooed on them, but never like the actual I'm gonna call it an implant.
Like
it ain't a nipple implant.
Silicones like they would do when you get like a mastectomy, and then they put a fake tit on there. And then they can tattoo the nipples on, or they have like silicone ones.
What about that bitch that you were watching on that dumper last night that had that nipple growing out of her forehead, and she had to fly to California and get that bitch removed?
That was a lipoma.
This bitch had a straight up fuck, dude. They gave a profile view, and this bitch, it was like a little baby toe hanging right off of her forehead, dude. Oh my God. She had made a wig. She had like a series of wigs that had bangs just to cover that bitch up.
And it still poked through.
Okay, hold on. No, hold on. Whoever, show me like with your finger, like whereabouts on the forehead, like it was sticking out from, like, was it directly in the middle or over here?
Right in the middle, bullseye, dude.
You could probably pull up a picture
fucking
of her.
Third eye. She just had her fucking third eye pulled off. Pull
up pimple head.
I'm going to pull up pimple head.
She got a whole fucking clit growing out of her forehead.
Dr. Pimple Popper Pimple Head.
That could be literally anything.
Well, Dr. Pimple
Popper. You guys watch that fucking show?
She tries to watch it while we're eating dinner and shit. Like, I ain't trying to look at this right now.
The little one, Lucas, he was like, Mom, are you going to watch Surgery? Because he calls it the surgery show. And I said, yeah, he likes to watch it with me. He's like, I wonder what color this one's going to be.
Oh, gross. I can't do it. I mean, look, I like a gross fucking video as much as anybody else, but just at my leisure, nah, I'm good.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's
the thing. That shit makes me, it just makes me dry heave.
Oh, yeah, you and me both, bro. And I just put in Dr. Pimple Popper forehead thinking that was going to come up with the one. And there's like 72 other ones that aren't the one. So, yeah, it's not that important. I'm not going to find this bitch. But trust, she had a fucking whole ass toe hanging off her head.
I can use my imagination. It's fine. I was just curious about where. Like, if it was kind of off to the side or something, you could explain it. But if it's right out the middle of your forehead, like you got a penis growing out of your forehead, that's rough, man.
You're literally a dickhead.
Yeah. Maybe if you put on Juggalo makeup, you could pull that off.
Is that still a thing?
There's 100% still Juggalos. If there's backyard wrestling, there's still Juggalos.
I was going to say, were you guys talking about that when I was pulling it up? Because for some reason, I have tunnel vision. When I'm typing shit and pulling shit up, I don't hear what y'all are talking about. It's like white noise.
Mm-hmm. No, we were talking about if people still wrestle, not so much if Juggalos. Juggalos are definitely a thing. They might have had a gathering recently. I don't know, on account of the COVID. Maybe
my brother usually goes to that because it's 3 days. And they just go in a tent and they get high for a week or whatever it is and then come home.
Sounds fun. I think the chicks that I've picked up throughout my life, other than my beautiful, lovely wife now, we're all just juggalettes. That's really the kind of chick that appealed to me through my life.
Arkansas, baby.
Yeah, dude. Where you come to settle.
It's a double meaning. I like it, dude. Fucking border tourism in there.
I'm just saying, dude, at certain points I lived out in the woods. So it's there were these chicks that I don't know why. They were just like, yeah, I'll come bang with you. And it's okay. And then there had to have been at least one of them that pulled up at my driveway and was just I'm about to get murdered. I'm in the middle of nowhere. And this guy's come hang out in my camper in the middle of the woods.
Wow.
When they pull up, I envision you coming out wearing overalls with no shirt underneath. And you spit off the porch and shit when they pull up. Is that accurate?
No, way worse. Probably full clothes, blue jeans, maybe a wife beater. Hey, guys. That kind of shit. Just
was
a dorky.
That before you were missing some of your face or after?
That was after, actually. I didn't get pussy until after I got shot, which surprises you as much as it did me.
No, it doesn't surprise me, dude. That's probably why you got it. They're like, hey, throw the kid with the half a face a piece.
Yeah. You know what? It's not totally true, actually, because there was an experience a little sooner than that, but I don't count that one really. So it's that was my first actually getting some pussy was after I got shot. The summer after I got shot, as a matter of fact.
No shit.
Yeah, dude.
You only live once.
So
that's kind of where I was at with it. I was I guess we're going to make this happen one way or the goddamn other.
Was it just any pussy or did you were you picky about it?
You know, I got really lucky. It was just my buddy's neighbor chick. Her name was Casey, and she was ugly, but she had a great body. Just
the start of all great stories. Her name was Casey, and she was ugly.
She
was a textbook butterface. Yes. Her teeth were all fucked up and she had freckles real bad. But she was curvy. It was wonderful. And that was the deal. The first time we hooked up, it was in the back of a motocross trailer, something you would haul a motorcycle in.
That's outstanding.
Was it enclosed?
It was. So that was the deal is like we kind of been fooling around a few days before. And then like we kind of made the plan. We're like, all right, you sneak out of your house and you come down. It's two doors down. She lives from, you know,
three doors down.
God damn it. It's in my head, on my tongue. I can't get it out. You took it from me.
Let me tell you this story. So I was so nervous. And she finally was like, yeah, I'll come down there. And I said, we're going to get in the trailer. I'll tell Mark, my buddy, we'll get in there, we'll shut the door, we'll do our thing, and then we'll fucking be on our way, you know? Mm-hmm. So we're fucking, we just finished. I'm going to skip to the good part. I mean, it was fine.
That's not the good part?
That's not the good part.
Like 3 minutes later.
Surprisingly, no, but also condom. So it just kind of is what it is. Like I got really lucky the first time. I was like, okay, and I probably jerked off 2 or 3 times that day. Let's be honest. Like prepping.
Yep.
How old are we talking?
16. It was the summer after I got shot. So yeah.
Wow, that's young.
Maybe 16 or 17. Yeah, somewhere. So that's what's crazy is we do our thing. It's awesome. You know, everything's cool. We're just kind of in that recoil spot. You know, like right after, kind of chilling. And all of a sudden we hear on the house door, like the garage, because it's the trailer parked next to the house. We're fucking in the trailer and the house is right there. We hear a knock on the door and it's like, uh-oh, who would knock? It's 1 o'clock in the morning, you know? Mm-hmm. It was her dad.
Yes.
And I feel like since he took all the trouble of getting in his truck and driving two doors down, like he probably wasn't in the mood for any of my shenanigans at the time. And like I said, I'm literally butt naked. She's looking for her stuff and it's dark, where there's no light.
Right.
So we hear the knock. My buddy opens the door and he goes, I want to know where Casey's at right now. And, you know, what's going on, this, that, and the other. And he could have said anything. He could have been like, I ain't seen her. Because at that point, nobody knew nothing.
Right.
My buddy rolled on me. He didn't even try to lie. He was just like, she's in the trailer.
I would. Now, was this a physically imposing gentleman that's coming at 1 in the morning? Did he have a reputation preceding himself? Like, I mean, there might have been some extenuating circumstances that caused him to roll so quickly, right? Like, let's give the man the benefit of the doubt.
Chris, I had never seen him before, so I had no clue. And the thing is, I found out later, I guess, I didn't see him that night either. Fortunately for me, he said, I want her, you know, in my truck in fucking however many minutes, whatever, dad stuff, you know?
Right. Because he knew what was going on.
My buddy walked over to the door, popped the fucking shit open, and he said, hey, you got to go home. And she jumped out, grabbed her shit, and went. I just sat there, like, staring at him, and he looked at me, and we're just kind of like, oh, shit, you know?
Locking eyes with an uncomfortable boner.
Dude, she fucking got in the truck and left. They went to the thing. I never saw her again. They moved like 2 weeks later. They moved away. So
shut the fuck up. You caused someone to move. You fucked them and you caused them to move.
I don't think that was it. Maybe there was other people that were getting dealt out. I don't know. It was just, you know, he didn't like that.
He didn't like it. I mean, I would tell people that. I'd be like, yeah, I fucked this bitch so bad her daddy made her move.
I'm glad we got boys, man.
Yeah, me too. You have no idea, Dutch. It's my worst fear. Just knocking down cocks all day long like a fucking with a slingshot. Pow, plow, plow, plow.
No way.
Mm-mm-mm.
Talking to you, Jason Almy.
I was just going to say.
Get ready for that, kiddo.
Yeah, I was just going to say, dude, like, I don't envy him.
Because
he's going to be extra.
Speaking of retards.
He's going to be extra anyway when that girl starts dating, dude.
I hope he gets back on the juice. You know what I'm saying? Like, wait till she gets to about 20. She's got just these little dipshits. Who knows what they're going to be like, what the hipsters are going to be like in 2045 or whatever the fuck, you know?
Holy fuck. Yeah, right. Like,
come here, son. Let me show you my steelbook collection.
Dude, when he's 60 and jacked, he looks like fucking Vince McMahon with a ponytail. Like, that's going to be awesome. He's like, look at all my awards. Like, I will break you in half.
Dude, did you catch him on the plunge stream this past weekend? Shit happens when you party naked?
Maybe not.
He was sitting at his desk with like his Mr. Olympia award sitting there. So he's got like this big bronze jacked up guy making muscles sitting there as he's talking. And I'm like, why? Why? What are you doing, dude?
Fucking dork. Put your guns away, dude. They ain't got time for that.
Oh, shit. Well, I tell you what, Jody, you gave me a couple pointers for my notes this week, but you didn't give me any context, man. So,
yeah, what did they say?
The first one said you wanted to talk about kids and games with the phone.
Okay.
Did something happen there?
So I listened to your show, and I've heard some of the escapades. I've recently joined the video game club with my kid. He's 5. Okay. And we started playing Xbox Lego games mostly.
Mm-hmm. Love those.
It's become a problem. And I'm worried. Like, I feel like a shitty parent some days. Nope. And like, nope. I'm having a little bit of a dilemma, but there's other days where I'm like, but he's smart and he knows how to listen and read. And sometimes he's a dick when I tell him he can't play anymore, but like, what am I supposed to fucking do? I can't hit him.
I'm gonna stop you right there, dude. You don't feel like a bad parent. You take advantage, dude. If all other boxes are checked, you let him fucking have that screen time. God damn it. If he's a dickhead and then he's taking the screen time, that's one thing. But if everything else is all good, you let him have that screen time. Because guess what? Then that gives you fucking 10 minutes to breathe.
It's one of those things, like, Dutch. I don't know, like, if you've noticed this, because I know, like, you're probably dealing with him a little more. But it's like, it's almost like drugs. It like, is. I've done drugs plenty of times. And it's like, no, you can't have this. And it's like, give me the fucking thing. Like, it's, yeah. No, Lucas, dude, you need to settle down. It starts to affect their whole fucking personality.
It does. It's the first thing that he wants when he wakes up, and he falls asleep with my phone, like on the weekends, because
yeah.
he doesn't have it, you know, with him when he goes to bed during the week because he's got school. But like tonight, he's been playing this game called Ragdolls or something, and he loves it. It's like Minecraft, and then he gets to like spawn cars that get thrown at him and stuff. I mean, but yeah, that's all he wants to play. We'll play the Lego games too, and I'll tell you what, you feel like a bad parent. I've straight up dropped the controller and said, I quit.
They fight in there. I got to go in there and ref them two, her and the boy. I got to go in there and I'll be like, what's the problem? Well, he won't do this. He keeps on coming over here and he's deliberately hitting me and he won't cooperate with the damn puzzle because he's got to pull this and I got to do that and he won't fucking do it.
We have to get 100% on these coins, Lucas. We have to hit 100 on these coins. And he's like going through the screens. I'm like, come back here. I need to get this blue one.
I feel it so much, Dutch. I really do. Like, we've been playing Lego Star Wars. And just, I try not to yell at him. Because, like, here I am. I'm a grown-ass man yelling at my 5-year-old kid because he won't walk over here. He understands English. And I can look at him and go, hey, man, will you fucking come on? Like, that's what I want to say.
No, I'd be like, bitch, we in story mode. You do your shit on free play. All right, we're in story mode now.
It's infuriating.
Let's do the story. No, it totally is infuriating.
He fucked around and bought some shit the other day. I had to change my passwords, put on the protection shit and stuff. Like,
they'll try you. They'll try
they
you.
They gave me my money back, so I wasn't mad at him after the fact. But during the moment, I was like, that's not okay, dude. Like, what the fuck?
Jody, let me tell you this. We had at our old place, we had a Roku upstairs, right? And at one point, we used to subscribe to Sling. Okay. we had the app on the Roku or whatever, but then I had discontinued it or whatever because I didn't want to pay for Sling no more. We changed providers. I don't know what the fuck it was, but we discontinued it, but the app was still there. And his non-reading ass was like, hey, that's where I used to watch my shit. Hits the thing, and they don't make it hard, dude. Like, you hit the fucking thing, and it's like, hey, you don't subscribe anymore. You want to start again? And he's like, goddamn right, Bubble Guppies is waiting. Fucking hits the fucking thing, and then I'm downstairs editing a podcast or something, and I get an email, welcome back to Sling. Gah, 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 gah. I go upstairs, I'm like, what the fuck you doing, bro? I want to watch this. I said, no. I stopped what I was doing, called fucking Sling customer support. I'm like, look, it's only been 10 fucking minutes, okay? I didn't want this shit. He did it on his own. You got to give me that money back. And they're like, all right, cool. We'll cancel it again. You know, sorry for the inconvenience or whatever. And I'm like, no, I'm sorry for you. Whatever. Legit, an hour fucking later, he does it again. And I got to get on the fucking Sling support again. And they were like, Did you just do this like an hour ago? And I said, yeah, my kid's doing it. He can't fucking read. And they were like, look, this is strike two. Delete the goddamn app off the Roku because strike three, you're going to be paying for that shit, player.
Right.
All right, cool.
I probably would have got belligerent at that point. I'd be like, number one, you don't fucking tell me what to do. Okay, motherfucker, I'm paying you. You shut the fuck up.
Are you a parent, bitch? All right, then.
I know, right? The first chick, she was so sympathetic. She was like, oh, my God, that's so cute. My kid would have did the same thing. Exactly. Da, 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 da. The second dude was like, hey, you just did this shit like an hour ago. I'm seeing through your bullshit here, guy.
I wish he would have. I fucking wish he would have. I'd have lit into his ass so fucking fast. It's like, oh, really? Is that you telling me how to raise my kid? How about this, asshole? You're at work, aren't you? Why don't you push the fucking button that cancels the shit that I just told you that I don't fucking want? And do your fucking job and shut your fucking mouth.
Well, I'm here to tell you, dude, Xbox will give you a couple freebies, too. It sounds like you already got one. They'll credit you back a couple times, too.
Lucas just did this a couple months ago. He bought $100 worth of Robux from Logan's Xbox.
He's such a snake, dude.
But he still is working on his reading. But I'm like, you know what it looks like when you purchase things.
Yeah, when shit says, are you sure? That's just when you need to be like, hold on.
He just hits buttons. He just hits buttons. And I asked him about it. And he's like, yeah, I did that. And I'm like, well, don't.
Well, see, I put the safe block on there now. So when you get to the point when it's like, are you sure? If you hit yes again, you got to put in like the whole ass goddamn contra code, dude. It's like fucking up, up, down, down, B, A, X, Y, fucking trigger, trigger, trigger. You know, like you got to have a whole sequence of goddamn events. You like launching a goddamn nuke on my Xbox just to buy some fucking games anymore.
No, I didn't go that far. I just went numbers. Like, sorry, little motherfucker. If you weren't paying so much Star Wars, maybe you'd learn your goddamn numbers and you know how to punch in a code, you know?
Well, see, I was going to tell you when she said he's been playing this new game or whatever, it's fucked up, but it is actually teaching him how to read in a roundabout way because he's using it kind of like sight words like they do in school, you know? So, like, he sees the shit so much, he knows what the fuck it means now. So, in a roundabout way, he is learning how to read. You know?
He'll be like, Mom, I want it to be green. I'm like, well, think about it for a second. What does green start with? You know? And then G, and then there's green and gray. I'm like, well, what letter does green have in it that gray doesn't? It's an N. So G-R-N. You could find the word green just with those little things. Bad.
I like that. That's way better, I think. Like cognitive, not critical thinking, but like common sense. Like,
yeah,
okay.
I'm just like, all right, this starts with what? All right, there's two that start with G. You know, it's just like, you know, method, what is it, deduction or whatever?
Yeah, deductive reasoning. Yeah, that's what I was sitting here going, what's the fucking word?
Do-do-do-do.
Because I'm like, I tell him, I'm like, I can't do everything for you. Hey, I want a juice bag. Well, go get it your fucking self. You can reach them. It's constant stuff. And it's like the older one too, man. I'm like, get your coat. Well, where is it? Use your fucking eyes. What are you going to do when I'm not around?
God bless your heart, man. You guys are playing man-to-man defense. I'm still playing. So it's cool. I don't envy that.
Well, it's the two-kid thing, dude. With the first one, it wasn't this way. When you add another man on the roster, you know, it becomes a little bit more intense.
I don't look forward to it. That's why I pull out. Hey, guys all around the world, don't leave it in there. Blow it on the tits.
I like having two kids. I don't know.
I tried to like having three,
it'd be
but
too
she,
much.
Because
then you
got to
do a new car. You got to get a bigger house. I don't fuck with.
I got
that
a
shit.
Big ass truck that would accommodate three
yeah,
kids,
well,
no problem.
You wouldn't have a studio.
I would not have a studio. There is that.
How about that?
There is that.
I'm good with two.
You would have most of a basketball team, though.
I'd have most of a starting lineup, dude.
If our kids played sports, I would love it.
Logan has taken shine to hockey. This past week, he tells me every day how they've been playing hockey at school. So
they're playing like ball hockey or something. Like what
the
fuck?
They
don't have ice.
No. Yeah, they're playing floor hockey, but you know,
he's like, I'm a good goalie.
I see, and when I drop him off too, I'm like, man, you guys got nice basketball courts. Yeah, I'm not into that. No, why not? You got nice facilities here, kid. Nope, not into that.
You're gonna threaten to beat him. Like, I'll cross your ass up, dude.
Mm-hmm. He wanted to do
with him.
Golf, and I'm like, rowing.
He's so lame, dude. Like, I said, what kind of sports you like? And he was like, well, I like golf, and of course I like fishing. And I'm like, sports, motherfucker, with others.
Team
can
sport.
Can I make one little suggestion thing? And not to shit completely on golf. I like a round of golf. I just never get to play. I suck, too. Don't leave that out. I've played maybe 40 times in my whole life. So
40's a lot, actually, a lot. Dude.
I think that was an overshot, actually. I'm going to back that down. Probably like 20 times
over
the years. And I got a set of clubs that are okay. I bought out a garage sale and shit. But no, if you're riding in the cart, like that's leisurely fat guy shit. Like what I like to do is you get high and drink and shit. If you're walking from hole to hole and you're a teenager, it's probably a pretty good way to get your steps in, if I'm being completely honest. It's not as expensive as you would think if it's like a school thing or some kind of extracurricular shit. If you're going to play at some snooty fucking country club, that's different. But there's a place here you can go play a round of golf for like $20.
Yep.
You know,
we got those.
I'll go to Top Golf. I'll go to Top Golf.
Oh yeah, we got Top Golf.
Yeah, driving ranges. You got plenty of shit to do, and it's not bad. It's actually probably more fun because there's not seasons. So like, it's not like baseball where there's, you know, 100 goddamn games in the seasons, 8 months long. Like, look, for bang for your buck, if you want to get it. Baseball's fine, but understand that is a lot of time to spend Saturdays running back and forth to fucking baseball games and bullshit like that.
Practices.
Yeah, I'm not into it, man. I told people when he was younger, I said, if he wants to play baseball, that's cool, man. I'll support him, but I hope he doesn't. I hope he doesn't want to.
Baseball's so fucking gay. I hate it.
I hate it too.
I think they should just fight. I think if it gets to the ninth inning, and like nobody's winning. I think they should just have a bench clear and then just last man standing wins. They gets to stand on the fucking the pitcher's mound and supreme victory.
That'd be great.
There was a time, shit, probably like 8-10 years ago now, I went for work because we used to sponsor like the Rays field here, so we'd have Miller Lite events and shit in there. And I drove a couple of guys. I drove my boss and I drove one of my other employees and shit. And because they wanted to drink and they were on vacation the next week or something. It's whatever it boiled down to. I was a designated driver, so I wasn't drinking and I drove them out there. And this fucking game went into like 19 innings, dude. It was like 3:30 in the fucking morning and I'm sitting there like asleep in the fucking stands and they're loving it. They're both drunk. Fucking three sheets to the wind doesn't even do it justice.
No, dude. They're extra innings drunk. Like, oh, that's fuck crazy.
Yeah, dude. And they're loving it. And I'm like, I have to get up for work in 2 fucking hours. I don't even want to be here. I didn't want to come to begin with. Let's go.
Yeah, I'd have made them ride in the back of the truck. Fuck you guys. For sure. Drunk assholes. You're not going to throw up in my shit. I don't want to hear you complain. Fuck you all. Get the back.
I'm so glad we don't sponsor that team no more. This is a tasty beverage, Jody. I have to say, I do like it. Maybe it's a tequila. I don't know, but it's a tasty beverage. I'm enjoying it.
That old COVID sunrise, man. It's a good fucking drink. I like it.
We might have to add that to the repertoire. Maybe we can use like something else, though. It doesn't have to be COVID, right?
No, it's fine.
So I don't drink a lot of... I'm so sorry, Dutch. Say what you were saying.
No, I said I think it's good, too. I just wish it was colder.
Yeah, it has to be cold.
Like a bucket of ice in here or whatever, because I made them all buckets. We need to like bring those back. Oh yeah,
that was OG, man. Like two of those three fucking buckets don't even have hosts anymore.
I know. True story.
We do. We do have another note here, and this one is actually looks like the fun note that you sent me, dude. We got Valentine's Day coming up, and you told me. I like how you give me no context, too, because I can't plan. You know I'm an over-planner and I'm an over-preparer, and I can't do anything with it. It just says Valentine's Day is Mr. Nasty Time, parentheses, suck start, comma, 69, comma, nipple clamps.
Yeah, man.
That's the start and the ending.
I cut it and pasted that. I didn't even, like, that's what you sent me. Like, that's a direct quote.
It's been a really crazy year, in my opinion.
It's been 3 weeks.
No. I'm just saying, like, dude, in the last year, we have really dealt with some shit. And the way I look at it this year, Valentine's Day is a weird holiday, especially for couples like that have been together for a while. Like, I'm not saying forever or whatever. It's just 10 years. If you've been together for 10 years, whether you've been married or not, like, that's a thing. You guys are double that. You know what I'm saying? So
yep.
I think that this Valentine's Day...
This is a public service announcement.
Guys, look, if you've managed to live with your partner in your house for the last year amid all this COVID bullshit with the lockdowns and the kids and the fucking all that shit, don't worry about presents. Don't worry about fucking big extravagant bullshit. Don't go out shopping. Don't do none of that shit. I think Valentine's Day this year should just strictly be Mr. Nasty Time. I'm all for it, man.
I say that's every year, bro.
No, like, I think the thing is, just like, you need to figure out something to do with your kids, maybe. Like, they have grandparents. They might get COVID. You got to be careful. Maybe a daycare. Take them to an arcade. Just, like, don't move for a while. And just go home and have some fun, man.
Just take a day off of work. We do that a whole week in September when it's our anniversary. So we don't really celebrate Valentine's Day or anything else. We just take the week off and do a lot of day things and...
She was feeling so good earlier today. She's like, I know our anniversary is not till September, but maybe we should take vacation earlier in the year this year. Maybe
it's so hot.
Celebrate our anniversary in like March.
It's so hot in September when we go. It's miserable. I don't even look good because it's so hot. And like my face is melting and everything's sticking to me and I probably smell weird. It was just such a beautiful day today. It's the sun and a breeze. It was so nice.
Hey, man, that's what I think. I think we're at the point now where we just need to take what we can get. And that was my other point is I was listening to somebody the other day complain about 69, and I don't know how you guys personally feel about that. I heard you talking with Riley, and they got all in your business. That's terrible. You guys.
They did. It added, you know what? I got to be honest, Jody. It did add to a tumultuous week for me. This was
Chris.
A hurricane of emotions this week, and it was all started with the goddamn fucking fundraising for the kids, dude.
Chris, those guys are knuckleheads. They were all in there. So look. I thought about it. Like, the best present you could give your spouse, and this is just my personal opinion, and I put it in the note there. If you really want to make your husband happy this year for Valentine's Day, suck start him. You know what that is?
I love it.
Well, you stuck on a soft cock?
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, that's fuck yeah.
Fresh out of bed. Like, I'm not even awake yet. Hopefully, I'm not snoring or anything and just being completely disgusting. But I'm saying, ladies, just take one for the fucking team. And you know what? You're in the process. Fucking, if you feel like it, you need to fucking climb up there and put your pussy on his face.
Dude, I was going to tell you, you continued on and you took my answer. I was going to tell you, I'll see you one more, dude. Wait until I'm asleep. I told her that when I was fucking 19, dude. I was like, there's nothing I love more than being asleep and waking up and you just going at it.
There's nothing I love more than being raped. So if you could manage that with your mouth,
I do. I'm a basic white bitch, dude. I got rape fantasies. Fucking hit me, choke me, whatever, dude. I'll make my mascara run. I don't give a fuck.
Goddamn. There it is. You married a monster.
I know. Well, I mean, I get like that too, but only after a lot of drinks.
And that's why she's like, sliding me her tequila shots over here tonight. She's like, you know what? It's not going to be me tonight.
I drink so much during the day.
She's fucking recouping.
It's not going to be me tonight. Yeah, she's fucking hungover and it's goddamn 10:15. Yeah.
This shit made me laugh, though. I was thinking about it the other day, and I was like, 69 is for young kids and for fucking married couples. That's really what it's for. It's for occasionally fucking get a suck start, get a 69. Do some reverse cowgirl. You can climb right into it from there, dude. Have a good fucking Valentine's Day this year, and don't bitch about not getting any presents. Get some dick and like it. Love it. I don't care if you're a man, woman, whatever. Fucking enjoy your fucking your home. Order in, stay there, and just love on your fucking person, because you managed a year locked in the house with them, and a lot of people didn't.
Yeah. Oh, no, yeah, for sure. A lot of people didn't. See, that's what people, you know, not to go down the COVID rabbit hole, but that's what a lot of people don't really factor in when they talk about, you know, all the devastating effects of the fucking COVID. I'm like, how many fucking people got divorced? How many fucking kids got their ass whooped last year because dad had nowhere to go? He didn't have fucking the goddamn hole at the wall at the corner to go sit at, you know, like. Yeah, how many kids didn't fucking eat? You know, like, there was a lot of extra shit, dude. A lot of extra shit. Dude, we were right before when we were waiting for you, I was scrolling through Facebook. A few weeks ago, we said how our local spot, Four Stacks, was closing down. And right before we came on tonight, I was scrolling through and they had a post on there. Fucking all their equipment's up for sale, bar stools, all that shit. I was like, that fucking breaks my heart, dude. Like, I recorded an episode at that place, man. Like, I fucking talked to that guy on a personal level. Like, that shit breaks my heart.
Mm-hmm. I'm just saying, if you win that $1 billion in the lottery, you can pretty much get a building anywhere. You could go to California. I hear that place is like fucking Walking Dead now.
Yeah. But you know what? And I that's kind of why I stopped listening to Rogan. Because I was telling someone this the other day. I said, I ain't listened to a Rogan in probably 3 months, like even before the Spotify thing. Like, I ain't listened to Rogan since October probably, and it's because no matter who it was, every guest that comes on, it's just like, so how you doing during COVID? LA sucks, right? And that's like an hour and a half. Fucking LA sucks, COVID sucks, lockdown, lockdown, lockdown. I'm like, god damn, dude, stop it. You're no better than fucking goddamn mainstream media, because all you're doing is pushing the fucking COVID, COVID, COVID. Let it go, bro. Let it fucking go.
Yeah. Everybody's dealing with it, man. And that's the thing, is that it's a good thing I sit on my episodes as long as I have, because I'm only going to have like 3 episodes with COVID mentioned in it.
That's funny. That's funny too. Because, I mean, you were telling people not to say it for that reason, weren't you?
I didn't tell anybody anything. It's just funny. Like, dude, this last year I've been at home. I've done projects and stuff. I got backed up. I haven't recorded my show but once in like the last 2 months. I've just been running off the shit that I've had backed up because I got tired of having that stockpile of shit. And I'm like, I'm just going to work through the shit through the holidays. Mm-hmm. I don't have to worry about scheduling nothing. I can do guest spots. I can go talk to my friends. I can do whatever the fuck I want.
Hell yeah.
That's
cool. I need to take a little break. I don't like pressure like that.
Come over here and light a fire under our ass, right?
Yeah, that's what I'm here for, guys.
Why not?
Jody, I love it still. That's the thing. Like, we've been doing this. Somebody, my buddy just, B-Rob, he just had his 5-year anniversary. That means I'm at 4 this February.
I'll be at 4 in July, I believe.
Sounds right.
I mean, I quit every week. Every episode's my last episode. So, I mean, I don't know if I'll see July, but fucking, I mean, July will be 4.
But Dutchie, you've been doing it for a year or 2 now, right? Full time?
I think 2 years.
2 years, yeah.
A lot of people don't make it that far, dude. They really don't. Like most podcasts, what, don't make it 10, 20 episodes? You guys are over 100 now, probably creeping on that second one.
This is 162. I forgot to drop it at the top, episode 162.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's awesome. You know, yeah, it's you got to keep it interesting, and you guys have managed to pull that off thus far. So now this is the, for me, I like to refresh my pool every year about this time when people get new shit for Christmas or, you know, they start doing podcasts. I sift through all the bullshit and I'm just like, hey, you seem cool. And then I fucking start chatting them up and trying to reel in some new victims. I mean, friends,
I people see to you. Hang out with. I see you. I don't really, dude, I'm so removed from social media anymore, but like I still watch and I see you, dude. Like I'm like, he's like that older guy that's like recruiting all these young 20 something twinks, dude. He's like, hey, who are you, little guy? Come on over here. Let me buy you a drink. Like who's he fucking talking to now? And then you're dropping their names like they're like, you know, mainstays. And I'm like, bro, who the fuck are you even talking about?
I'm a papa bear. I like fucking bringing people under my wing. Get up under the fan.
Everybody's a nobody until they're somebody.
Mm-hmm. Words to live by. Mm-hmm. Duchess dropping nuggets.
I'm so misinformed.
You are. You're so misinformed. You're racist and you're just not funny.
That's what I feel like. She's almost holding back. Like I'm looking at her and I thought maybe it was because I was talking too much, but I've been trying to throw it to you. You just want to drop an F-bomb or something? Like you got it, dude. Talk to somebody, a faggot bitch, cunt.
Joe, you're not supposed to say that.
I'll fucking go further, but I really don't want to. I don't want to spoil the sanctity of the show. I like you guys.
Sanctity.
I got a question from a listener, and you know, we've been talking about the kids, and it's kind of related. I know my stance, but I'm curious to hear what y'all say. This is from somebody named Elizabeth. I don't know who that is.
Probably a bitch.
Yeah.
A bitch fucking cunt.
There she goes.
Bitch named Beth.
There she is. Yeah. It says, it was my son's birthday and one of his friends is vegan. I knew this ahead of time, so I had some options, but when I wasn't looking, this kid scarfed down a hot dog. Would you tell the parents or act like it didn't happen?
Act like it didn't fucking happen.
Not my problem, bro.
Eat a fucking hot dog. That kid isn't vegan because of his choice. He's vegan because his parents are making him be a fucking vegan.
See, we didn't go over the play beforehand. I didn't pull you into the huddle and tell you what was on my mind. That was my stance as well. So, brava. Kisses.
Hang on, guys. I've had like 10 seconds to think about it. I'm trying to be progressive in Joe Biden's America. So let me marinate on this for a second. Oh,
Jesus Christ.
Hey, you better watch your reactions over there, Miss Racist, okay? Don't be fucking saying shit.
Bernie's mittens.
Listen, I caught the shit into this deal not too long ago. It was probably a year or two. We were going to see some friends, and they had a barbecue. And it's kind of the same thing. Like, these are shit-kicking. They got, like, a farm animals and stuff. Like, these are just country folks. And they had a little party for the baseball, soccer, softball, whatever the fucking thing was. And one of the kids, like you said, couldn't eat regular hot dogs. So I show up hours later, like everything's put away in the fridge, and they're like, oh, you guys want some food? We've got some. We can just warm it up. And I'm like, yeah, sure. And I grab a hot dog off the fucking thing and put it in a bun, put it in a microwave. And it looked like a hot dog. It looked a little weird, like maybe it had been cooked earlier and all kind of wrinkled up and shit. But I was like, it's fine. And I took a big bite out of it. And have you ever just chewed on something like and just it? You keep chewing and you're just like, this isn't right. And you're like, your throat literally will not swallow it. Like, I just kept.
Yes.
Dude, that happened to me on a space cookie once.
Yeah, no shit.
You swallowed that shit. Don't even try.
No, I couldn't eat the sandwich after, is what I'm saying.
True. I got a cast iron stomach, man. I could eat almost anything. But there was a moment there where I literally was like, I'm going to have to spit this out. Like, I can't fucking swallow this. And I said, what kind of weird fucking hot dogs are these? And they go, oh, the vegan kid, blah, blah. So. I understand they have to have some other kind of thing for that.
Nope.
I personally don't think that you shouldn't get to have that.
I personally think that if your kid's a vegan and you're going to a fucking party, you bring your own goddamn vegan dogs.
Well, she said she had an option. I like that too. She said she had the option because she knew the kid, you know, like she knew the kid was going to be there or whatever. So she had shit for him. But like my thing is if he's sneaking regular Oscar Mayer fucking wieners, he ain't too stoked to be a goddamn vegan. So he's like, here we go. Nitrates. Get them in my belly. I need them.
That's a good question. Does the kid suck? Like, because you guys know you've met some of your kids' friends, like, is he a shitty little kid or is he cool? And you know,
right? No, I don't. Shit, I don't know. Being me, if I knew my kid, if I was vegan and my kid was vegan, and I knew that he was going to a party, I would send him with a gift for the child and a pack of hot dogs. a pack of vegan dogs to give to the
You would, too. You would, too.
Because it shouldn't be anybody else's responsibility to cater to me. If I'm going to a party, you either eat what they have or you don't fucking eat. That's what I tell my kids. I'm like, when Logan spent the night at his friend's house a couple weeks ago, I'm like, listen, you know they're not going to have the same food in their fridge that we do, right? And he's like, I know. I've been talking to myself about being a guest.
Yeah, don't be a fucking snob asshole. Right. Eat the potato chips.
I'm like, they're not going to have Red Baron pizza.
He's psyching himself up.
You might have to eat a different flavor goldfish or a juice bag or whatever. And I mean, it all was fine, but it's, you know, just you have to not cater to people like that. But yeah, I may be misinformed and rude.
But that was my whole thing, too, because, I mean, I imagine these are little kids. If she's like, should I tell the parents? And I was like, why are you forcing this shit on some little kid, making him fucking not have a goddamn hot dog? That's a rite of passage as a child, man, to have a fucking hot dog. Come on, man.
Well, I feel like with our children, too, I mean, they wouldn't know what a donut was unless we told them what it was. Maybe this kid didn't know what a regular hot dog was. Maybe he just grabbed it and said, this shit is good, you know?
Oh, he knew. But, he got away from his stupid fucking mom and was like, game on. They got real.
I'm sure he's had it somewhere else too, you know. Because I don't know. It just rubs me the wrong way. Like, let kids. She's got to cook
him hot dogs at home. Like, I'd rather you have hot dogs at home with me. Like, it's fucking beer and shit.
Sit in the closet eating Lay's potato chips and shit.
That's who you're creating. Yeah, that's the kind of environment you're creating.
It is true. Like, kids will get damaged from that shit.
Fuck yeah. Dude. Well, kids are going to get damaged from everything. That, you know, that's one of the biggest fears I have is how much I've already fucked up my kid in 11 years and what I'm going to do in the next fucking 11. And then, it, you know, 10 years after that, when he's got whatever version of a fucking podcast in 2050, then he's going to be on there talking shit about me. You know, like, that's my biggest fear.
He thinks he's a grown ass man and I'm going to have to be laying into him. It's going to be fun.
Because you're going to be on episode fucking 1500 and shit. You're going to be like, God damn it. Yeah, I know you're old man. Don't make me call him, you cocksucker.
Welcome to my dad kicked my ass cast, episode 1-A.
Dash A.
Everybody's going to fuck their kids up a little bit. It's just, you know, to what extreme, I guess. I've kind of made peace with that, and I try really hard not to do it too bad, but I have my fucking moments where I'm just like, I love you so much more than the people that raised me love me.
Well, that's what I was going to say. I mean, I know you've come up a little bit harder than most. So, I mean, like, I think your kid's going to come out better for it, man. Exactly. He's going to be A-okay.
I hope he's not a cunt. Like, I really just, I'm trying hard, like, to teach him politeness and manners and stuff. But just some days, I'm like, buddy, you can't just be a dick like that. Like, I don't know what to say. You're 5, so I'm going to give you a pass today. But moving forward, I'm going to need you to fucking take that shit down a notch, because you yell at me like that in Kroger, I'm going to fuck right up, leave you in a freezer.
What else we got? What else we got? Jodie, we've been watching a show on Netflix that I actually wanted to talk about a couple weeks ago, and I never got around to it. And then when the stars aligned and I heard you were coming on, I felt it was fitting for you. I felt like you would have a take on it. And I mean, do you fuck with a lot of Netflix shows? Are you a Netflix guy? I know you got your cartoons and your shit. You just get high and watch Yogi Bear and shit, but I don't know if you venture too often to Netflix.
No, I cut the cartoons off, actually. I got Delvin's HBO Max password, so I've been watching the cartoons on there now. Thanks. Shout out, Delvin. Nice. Appreciate you, bro.
I shot him out a couple weeks ago for helping me get this Xbox, dude. Delvin is helping all of us be entertained throughout fucking COVID times, dude.
Oh, DC's a gangster, and he can have my Disney password if he wants it. I don't give a shit, bro. Holler at me. I got Hulu. I got Amazon. I got beans, greens, tomatoes.
Games.
Dude, so I've watched Netflix quite a bit, but we've kind of slacked off with all the other stuff. HBO's killing it. Like, they're still dropping all these movies and shit, right?
Highly underrated. I love HBO, dude.
Digging through it. HBO is a good bet right now. You know what else? We bought the Discovery app that has all the other shit on it. It's like $5 commercial free, and you get like 15 networks. It's like Food Network, Discovery, History Channel, a bunch of shit that we watch anyway. And I was like, fuck it, dude. Let's cut off all that other bullshit and let's do that. So.
Mm-hmm. But we have Spectrum, so we don't, because I looked into that too, but we have all that, both channels on Spectrum.
That's our cable. We got regular. Because
we have to have internet, so.
Yeah, they fuck you. I get it. We ain't got to talk about that. But no, so Netflix, I've been watching a few shows, and this one you're talking about, I actually watched an episode just to humor you when you told me about this.
Did I tell you about it?
You did?
Oh, dude, I swear to God, Riley needs to raise money for me because I don't even know what day it is, man. I had no idea that I even mentioned this to you, what it was. So for the sake of the audience, I'm talking to about the Netflix show called Surviving Death, and it's like a five-part series. Mm-hmm. And it's definitely in my wheelhouse. Like when I put the first episode on, I was like locked from the time it started. Like we were getting dinner together, and like I was sitting there, and normally I will have, like, we get Public subs, right? Like a big ass fucking Public subs, and they cut them bitches in half. And she eats half, and I'll have my whole thing done by the time she gets done with her half. And then she saves her half for the next day, but my shit's fucking put away. And she got done with her half, and I hadn't even, like, picked mine up yet because I was just, like, so fucking locked in with what was going on, man.
Just sitting there, mouth agape like an asshole, right on the edge of the couch.
Dude, like, it was...
Pretty much. I had to be like, are you okay?
The first episode of this series, dude, it brought me to tears multiple times, dude. Like,
I watched it. That was the only one I watched because I figured that was the best one. That you watched first, and I said, okay, I'll check this out, and it actually kept my attention. It was a crazy episode, man, for sure.
So the lady in the beginning, the first story with the kayak, dude, like that one hit me so, like, she was like, I was dead for 30 minutes and what
spoiler,
like,
alert.
Well, I mean, like, you're gonna watch it, it's within the first fucking 10 minutes, but I mean, just hearing her account of, like, you know, like there were all these beings or entities and shit, like, I'm like, that's exactly what I'm with you, man. Like, I'm fucking, we're like tractor beamed, man. Like, she had me from jump, and I wanted to talk about it just because, like I said, like, it felt like all these stories of these people that went through that shit was confirming, like, stuff for me, because I mean, like, obviously I didn't almost die, but like I had a little bit of like an out-of-body experience in the float tank, and I think that it probably has something to do with shutting off your brain and shutting off your senses and all that shit. And if anything is a good mimic for, like, near death, it's being weightless and fucking senseless and floating in the dark. So I mean, like, maybe that's like a trick or something. And I experienced some crazy shit too, man, and I mean, I think that's why I connected so much with it. And then when I heard, or we scheduled you coming on, I was like, fuck, dude, that's Mr. Goddamn Near Death Experience. So, I mean, I hope to God he's got a fucking take on this shit, man.
Well, Thatch, what do you think?
About life after death?
Did you watch, the episode too? You kind of got through it? Like,
I got through it, and I think it's pretty fucked up, because the one that did it for me was the lady who knew that she was going to die at childbirth.
Yeah,
that's the one. Like, when she was having premonitions and all that, and that's the one that did it for me. And then she could see everything that's going on around her and all that stuff. And she could say what the doctors were saying, what tools they used, all that stuff.
Well, that was scared to get out of here, right? Because then it makes those lucid fucking nightmares and dreams, those weird little fucking things that you have when you're sleeping, and it's just one of those things that happens when your brain is organizing files, but you have a fucked up dream, and then you hear that lady say some shit like that, and you go, like, I can never have dreams again, because you never know, that might be the one time that fucking blah, 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 blah. You know, it just,
well, that's crazy. That other lady that they made her, because she had the aneurysm in her head, and she was clinically dead, but she was still thinking. Like, there were no brain waves on the equipment. But she
was it? They had to kill her. They had to stop her heart, slow it to it stop.
Drain her blood. That was the one that got me, dude. Drain her fucking blood.
They had to drain her
blood
to shrink the aneurysm.
It can be quick, right? Like, that has to take a moment. If it takes 15 minutes to drain the oil out of a Chevy, like, it probably takes at least 30, 45 minutes to get all the blood out of your body if you're letting it out slow.
Brain activity whatsoever.
I think they said for an hour. Yeah, I think for an hour.
But she was also able to say, this is the tools that the neurosurgeon used. This is what I saw. And they're like, her eyes were taped shut the whole time. There was no other explanation for her being able to.
Makes me feel kind of bad because, like, these people, you know, had these severe moments. And I'm thinking maybe it's like heart death is the thing that leads to it. Because they said you can have a near-death experience like this from, like, heart attacks and stuff too. Just, it's basically when something vital stops working. Now, I got fucked up pretty bad, but nothing vital of mine ever stopped working. Like, my heart was still pumping. My brain was still functioning. contrary to popular belief, but you know what I'm saying? Like, I was still all there. I just happened to have taken a fucking a piece of hot lead through the jaw. So
I didn't know if maybe you had some sort of like moment of clarity or anything like that. Or you were down for a while too. Like, didn't you say like once you got to the hospital, like you were out of it for a few hours or whatever. I didn't know if maybe like when they knocked you out or anything, you had some sort of.
So you guys both watched the show, so you'll understand. Like, there were some things that were relatable. Like, they were talking about the time stopping thing, like that whole thing. Mm-hmm. That's very real. Like, for a moment, it's like just your brain trying to process, like, trauma of trying to put the pieces together.
Right.
Because with mine, I got shot so fast. Like, it's just, it's the blink, it's half a blink an eye. It's so fucking fast. And that was the deal, is it was like, boom. And then like, sound kind of, I've described the sound, I did it on Jason's show. It's like if you were underwater and you heard somebody banging cymbals. Like, that's the sound that kind of, or almost if somebody was meditating, like rubbing a fucking thing, right? It's just kind of a.
Well, your ears are probably ringing or something because it was so loud.
Correct. And that could very well be that for sure. It wasn't, but because I've had that before, just that whee, like I've had that. It wasn't that. It was different. Deeper, like had more of a kind of a sound. And then, like, everything went white when it happened. Mm-hmm. So it's like I was looking over here, and I turned back, and when I was fucking turning back, and so everything stopped, sound, white light, and then I just kind of felt myself fucking
fall
down. Mm-hmm. And then as soon as I hit the fucking seat, snap back to reality. Oh, there goes gravity. Oh, there goes.
You son of a bitch.
I got a hole in my face.
It was so fucking crazy because I didn't feel it. Like, I didn't feel anything. I was just like, 1 second I'm over here, and then pow, like just boom. Like, it's so fucking loud. And then all of a sudden, like, I'm looking. He's got one of those, like those Indian blanket seat cover things, you know? Like, one of those weird, it's a pickup truck, old school pickup. So, like, I wake up and I'm looking at just that woven shit in, like, my pants. Little bit of blood, you know, I'm kind of like, oh shit, you know, and as I start to come up, I see my hand, and I just pick my hand up like you would anything else, and my middle finger is like way the fuck over here.
Oh no.
Like, dangling. This finger is fucking over here, like it's just, I thought it just blew my hand apart like a firework or something, and I was like, oh shit, you know,
like that. Yeah, that's and bad enough, you know, not really realizing.
Had no idea. And then all of a sudden I start bleeding down my shirt, and I'm like, all right, and I look, and yeah, sure enough, it was like Texas Chainsaw Massacre shit. Like, my thing was opened up, and I was like, God damn, that's not good. It didn't hurt. I didn't feel anything, but I was like, I'm shot in the face. Like, I'm going to die for sure. Like, you don't get shot in the face and not die. And here I am. Like, I'm pretty sure that's what happened.
You know what? And maybe it's got something to do with the age, because I mean, you were so young. The gravity, I don't want to say the gravity of the situation didn't set in, because obviously, you know, at 15 or fucking 35, what being shot in the face entails. I mean, you said it yourself, you thought you were dead, but maybe it's like that. I don't know. Maybe that had something to do with it not being, I don't want to say like profound, because I mean, I'm sure it changed your, obviously, it changed your life, you know?
It's one of those things where it's like you realize you have no control of the situation, and your brain is telling you, by all accounts, you know, every other time you've heard this story, you know what happens next. But I didn't feel like I was dying. Like, I didn't get cold. I didn't get, you know, it was all these, you build it up in your mind, like what to expect. And then when you're in that moment, it's just kind of, like you said, it's almost clarity. It's peaceful. Like, you're just kind of like, okay, like, I feel fine. Like, let's just get it. And I'm sure a lot of people die feeling that way. Like, they're like, I'm fine. No problem. And then like their top half falls off their bottom half and shit.
Yeah.
See, and like, I related to that pregnant lady with the premonitions a lot too, just because like I've said it before on the show, and I know she gets mad at me when I was saying it, but like I legit, and it sounds crazy to even say, but I legit thought that I was going to die before I turned 40. And my birthday was the end of December. That was my 40th birthday. And in November I had COVID, and I'm like, are you fucking shitting me? This is how it happens. I'm going to be one of the fucking 0.5 that dies from this shit. Really? That's how I'm going out. Okay, well, I guess so. And then I pulled through COVID. Everything was fine. So I'm like, huh, you know, and it's been on my mind. Like, it was legit weighing on my mind. I was losing sleep over this shit. I thought I was going to fucking die sometime in December.
Wouldn't it have stuck so fucking bad just to have called the shot? You don't want to be that Babe Ruth.
But then like I'm flying to New Hampshire and you'd never want to have that thought. But as I'm like taxiing down the runway and I'm getting ready to lift off, I'm like, maybe this is it. Maybe this fucker's going down, you know, like, you know, I guess we'll see, you know, and I land, everything's fine. Then there's the COVID scare in goddamn New Hampshire. And I'm
COVID
like,
COVID scares every fucking where.
Well, yeah, obviously, but you know, just everything stacking up. And on the way back, when I was flying back, I was listening to an episode of a podcast called Tinfoil Hat that I listened to. And it's like conspiracy theory, you know, fucking spiritual shit that I'm into. And they just happened to have this woman on there that was like this near death experience woman. And like, she was telling her story and we're in the air and I'm just listening to it and I'm vibing out. I got my eyes closed and shit. And like, I just started feeling myself like tearing up, dude. Next thing you know, like, she's telling her story and I got tears rolling down my face. And I'm like, fuck, dude, maybe it's going down on the return trip. What the fuck, man? Like, I legit thought that my time was up. And I couldn't tell you why, dude. I couldn't tell you fucking why in the slightest.
Maybe
I hope you get over that. Yeah.
Sometimes I think you want to die.
I don't though. But see, it's like what Jodie was saying though about being peaceful about it.
You need to suck starting more. That way, it's got something to live for. You know what I'm saying?
Well, like,
put your pussy on his face.
Well, like you were saying about being peaceful. You were talking about being peaceful. That's kind of like, in all of, like, I don't want to call it my research, but in everything that, like, I like this path that I've gone down, like, I kind of, that's why I was relating so hard with this woman about, like, you know, she's there and she sees, like, the you know, entities or whatever on the other side, and like everything's just like fucking like love and colors and like everything's okay. And I'm like, that, I buy into that shit, dude. So like, I was like, if it is my time, I'm kind of made peace with it, dude. And I'm 39 years old. There's no reason I should even be fucking thinking about that, but it was in my brain. It was like, now's the time, motherfucker. It's happening.
I'm going to tell you this, and I mean, no disrespect to anybody's religion that happens to be listening to this, but in that moment of my panic and my fucking thinking I'm going to die, I didn't see shit. And maybe that scared me a little more than anything else, because there wasn't nothing else. It was me and doctors and people that put my shit back together and just happened to know what they were doing. And they were all from other religions too. So, I mean, I don't know who was doctor, whose God was praying to who or whatever the fuck, but they managed to pull it off. And that's cool. I think in my research as of late with, you know, taking in a bunch of different angles, I think that when you die, or when you get scared to a point, like your heart stops, there's definitely like a point of no return. Just like there's other involuntary reactions in your body, like coming or whatever the fucking thing is, like there's different things that you really can't control, farting. It just is what it is. And I think that it's DMT. I think it's your brain will release a shot of DMT when you die.
No, for sure.
If you're lucky enough to have that moment, because if you just die, like, it's, you know, you get cracked in the head with something, you fucking just die. Like, you might not get that adventure. Right. But I think if you pass over, especially, which is kind of crazy when you think about old people like laying in the hospital dying and they're sitting there in their own fucking planet and you just think they're going through the kaleidoscope of life, just seeing fucking aliens and gremlins and fucking colors and shit.
Mm-hmm. I think, but that's no. The gas though, Jody, like, I feel like I read something and it sounds like it's like from a gift shop t-shirt, but you know, it makes sense. It's, you know, like, we're not humans that have souls. We're souls that have bodies, because like, mm-hmm. I look at it like, the soul is the you, the body is like the car, and you get in that as a vehicle and you're just navigating through. This is, you know, what we, this,
yeah,
is
we're energy.
This is what we're just navigating through, this body. So when that body dies, I mean, obviously that's not the end of you. Like, you, it's my belief that you're here for a reason. And if you accomplish that reason, then you fucking, you know, elevate to the next level of the game or whatever you want to call it. But if you don't, then you got fucking doink, doink, to do, you try it all over again, you know, like, got to get it right.
Maybe. Yep. Something has to happen when you come off that DMT trip, because unfortunately DMT only lasts like 15 minutes, and then you come back from the aliens, I guess. So, and somebody that had been doing DMT told me about that, because that's what he said. All the things are true. Like, when people say you get a heavy enough dose of that, like, you'll see fractals and all kinds of goofy shit. And it's not like, I'm going to try to think of the best way to put this. Like Joe Rogan does DMT, talks about it. I think a lot of people have gotten into it, and this is my assessment of DMT. I think that maybe there's some things that you're only meant to see once. Mm. From my personal opinion, I have a lot of things in my head that I don't really need to open the book on right now. And so I don't fucks with psychedelics a lot, which sucks. If it's helping people, great. But for me, I'm good. I think that the people that take that stuff that can't understand, like it's just a chemical that makes your brain fucking do shit, probably when you die, can't process the idea of like, it's just that. It's just a chemical thing in your brain that's going to make your fucking see all kinds of shit. Do you go on to another dimension? Maybe. I don't know. But it's all the same. Like it's the drug experience, dying. It's all the same feeling. And it's, I don't want to feel that, but once in my life, if I have to.
Yeah.
Cause I've you'll spend all your time trying to get back there, trying to figure it out. You're not supposed to understand it, man. It's not meant to be understood. It's meant to be your passing into whatever dimension or whatever your next thing is, because you're dead. Who gives a shit? Like you can't complain. You're fucking dead.
Well, it's like the guy that was on the show, too. He was telling a story about how when he passed away, he saw his dad in the ocean, and they could never say that they loved each other in life. I'm with you on, I feel that your brain, when that something like that happens, sees what it wants to see, and that it's more of a chemical thing. I do believe that there's energy that goes on beyond that, but maybe that's just the first step. The first step is your brain seeing what it wants to see, and then the next step is going on living your energy in another way, or staying here, or the other episode that I like that you haven't gotten to yet is when kids are saying that they've been.
Oh, that was a good one. That's the last one. The first one they bookended it. The first episode and the last episode are the two. The ones in the middle. Yeah. That's Travel Channel fluff, dude. That's medium shit. That's fucking channel shit. Dude,
I zoned out on the first one. I put it on for 10 minutes, and I rolled my eyes so fucking hard. I looked at my wife, and I go, I can't do this.
Yeah, watch the last one.
That one's really interesting. But going back when you were saying when you had gotten shot and you didn't feel any pain, I had gotten bit by a dog a long time ago, and it was the same for me. I didn't feel any pain when the dog bit me. It was just really warm, and it was just – I feel it was just adrenaline rushing through your body, and it was getting rid of all the pain sensors.
Adrenaline is amazing. That's a great fucking drug that your body produces, just like other things. It's just, there's no reason that your arm, that your finger, Chris, Dutch, my fucking finger was over here. Like it was hanging on by a piece of meat, thinner than a piece of beef jerky. And when I picked my hand up like this, the shit was dangling off. And I was like, oh shit, like, that's a real fucking problem. Like I'm seeing bones and meat. Past the white meat, I'm all the way down to the red meat, motherfucker. Yeah, like, this shit was down to the muscle. Bones. I'm just looking at that going, this is not okay. Like, I don't know what's going to happen next. Hopefully, they got some good doctors on call in Camden, Arkansas. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm surprised they didn't use a fucking staple gun to put my shit back together. Just pat, pat, pat. He'll be okay.
Well, that's that woman on the show with the kayak. I mean, like, she even said it. She was fucking kayaking in Chile in the 90s. And she was like, for whatever reason, dude, when they pulled her out, they came out of the woods and there was just an ambulance there. She's like, that doesn't happen in the 90s in fucking Chile, dude. I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. Like, but there was an ambulance there ready to take me to the hospital.
But then take it even further. Then she had to go to a Chilean hospital in the 90s, and she'd just been dead for like 30 minutes. Like, this whole story should not happen. Like, this is absurd.
It hit me, dude. It hit me so hard.
And for her not to have any brain damage whatsoever.
But then...
Oh, tell them the worst part. Yeah, tell them the worst part.
The kicker is the entities on the other side fucking tell her that her kid's going to die. And she brings that knowledge back with her, and then her kid fucking dies. Like,
not
that's
18, but
like, dude, good. It's
so my question is, how long do you think she held on to that? Because that happened early on, right? Like when she talked to the spirits, they said your kid's going to die, right?
She held it till his 18th birthday. Then had a conversation with him and he took it for what it was. And then it was 2 years later that he was hit by a car.
It's it's
while fun. Rollerblade ski skating,
like, or whatever. Like dry, it's like a roller hockey, but with skis. It's like dry land roller skiing or something.
What a dick bag. I probably would have hit him too, just for fucking roller skiing or whatever the fuck he was doing.
He was in Maine, dude. What else are you gonna do?
Fish.
not fucking roller ski. You can go moose hunting. You can just go fucking hang out, I guess. I don't understand. Like, bicycles are bad enough. Roller skates are bad enough. But the pompousness of a white person to strap skis with fucking wheels on it, to just be like, you wouldn't to just have the fucking urge to run one of them motherfuckers over if it was in the middle of nowhere. It's just like, you know what, dude? Not today. You don't know.
How dare you? How dare you, sir? I tell you what, though, dude. Skip those other episodes and go to the last one and watch the one with the kids, dude, because there was this little kid on there. He was, what, 5 years old, babe?
Yes.
And he was telling his parents that, like, he was a fighter pilot, and they shot his plane down in World War II and shit. Gave him a name. Gave him the name of the ship. They checked it. It checked out. Gave him the name of his friend on the fucking – on the ship. That name of that friend was on the log of people on that ship, dude. Like, it was fucked up. The parents took the kid on a boat to fucking Japan, dude. They went to goddamn Iwo Jima and shit, like, where the plane went down, and, like, had, like, a little memorial service for it. Kid never mentioned it again. Never.
He put it to rest.
Never fucking mentioned it again. But until that time, he was all about it. He was like, hey, I lived before, and this is me, and... It, dude, that shit fucks me up,
too. One of the other kids was a Hollywood movie star in a past life.
In the 30s, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
God damn, guys. Like, I know you love your kids and all, but how much would that cost? A plane trip for three to Okinawa, Japan?
Yeah.
I guess if you make that much money, it doesn't matter.
Well, that's like some severe, like you said, that the pompousness of these white privileged motherfuckers that are like, we got to get the spirits out of you. Hold on.
No, that is a very good point. Like, how come little fucking trailer park kids don't ever get possessed by rich old dead white people or soldiers or something?
Right. Well, they probably do. They just get fucking beat and told to go back and up about it, you know?
Yeah, that's what it is. It's fucking, their fucking alcoholic parents are just like, well, get back in your cage then, you fucking gook. And they stick them,
I can't
stick them with a broom.
I can't afford another mouth to feed. There's only one of you, goddammit.
Sometimes I feel like Lucas might have had a past life just because of how he acts with him only being six. I don't know if it's because he has an older brother, but just his dry sense of humor that he has and the way that he just speaks, it's crazy because Logan was never like that.
Asking me fucking shit like what's on the back of the moon. Like, dude, you're fucking six. Don't be asking me about what's on the back of the moon, because you know that you're going to get me with that, goddammit. Like,
yeah, none of your business. That's what's on the back of the moon. Cheerios.
I was having a conversation with one of them. We were riding home the other day. Well, I talked about it a couple episodes ago. The one asked me what's past the end of the world, and then we started talking about some flat earth shit. But then the other one, I don't know what we were talking about, but I was like, "Do you think dinosaurs might still be alive?" And he hit me with like some fucking straight up, well, oh, the only 5% of the ocean has been explored, and there's 75% of the planet is water. So, I mean, it's not out of the realm of possibility that deep down in the ocean that there's something that could have survived throughout the... Like, who the fuck are you, player?
That's me, man. I'm all about the ocean. Like, that's my child.
Damn, he just started rattling off like at the, like... Like, oh,
that's what he watches on YouTube. When Logan watches YouTube, he watches all that deep ocean stuff. He watches conspiracy theories too.
He does. Like, there's right
around shit down there, bro. Like, we haven't been very far in the ocean. Fuck all that up in the sky shit. We can't do much about that. I'm just saying, down there, if you'd be submarining to find them goddamn Godzilla monsters.
Hell yeah, dude.
Them kaijus.
Bro. The Krakens, they're all down there just hanging out.
You think it's so? Like, when we go
fuck them up, bro? No, not at all. I fucking
she's Jodie. I was hesitant to even talk to you a little bit about this, just because I know you don't subscribe to the creature shit that I subscribe to. You know what I mean? Like, you're pretty no nonsense. Like, the world is the world, and that's that. You know, kind of shit. But I'm like, I gotta fucking ask, because when you came on a couple years ago and you told the story about, you know, when you got shot. At that point in time, I hadn't unlocked this portion of my brain yet, so it never even occurred to me to be like, hey, did you have some sort of fucking out-of-body, some sort of near-death experience? Did you talk to somebody? You know, I was just like, whoa, your face, bro.
Yeah, I get that a lot. Not so much since I'm getting to wear masks lately. I haven't scared a kid in like 3 months. It's been pretty cool. I can go to gas stations and Walmart, and like, people don't stare. They don't walk up and ask me what happened. It's pretty sweet.
Turning lemons into lemonade. We're making positivity happen over here at the hashtag No Offense Show.
There you go.
That's the COVID sunrise right there, baby.
That's it. Bam. I could actually probably use another one if my bartender will
It's all warm.
I don't give not one fuck. It's goddamn 11 o'clock and you've had me drinking since 2.
What can I say?
Hey, dude. I'm trying to get her to sit on your face. You probably need to stop talking so sassy and ask her politely for a beer, bro.
She's got to work in the morning. That ain't happening, dude.
God damn it.
That ain't fucking happening.
Just hit that bottle then. That's what time it is now. Welcome back to the hashtag we don't give a shit show. We're having tequila shots and getting fucked up on a Friday.
Nice.
Yeah, I appreciate you coming on, dude, because you're getting us back on schedule. I told her earlier, I was like, we're both fucking tired. We're experiencing like hangovers at 10 o'clock and shit. And I was like, this would have been a classic example of us just going, let's just do it tomorrow. And then tomorrow comes and it's like, I don't feel like it now either. I guess we'll just skip this week.
And then we'll do like a Tuesday.
And then we'll do, we'll fucking do a Tuesday.
No, I fucking love you guys. And that's, I felt a little bad for being late. And when you clicked the video on, I saw you sitting all back in your chair, all fucking just chilling, maxing, fucking. I go, oh man, I might have been too late. Like, they're already fucking tuning down. So I'm glad that you guys fucking perked up for me. I appreciate that.
Yeah, that's just the vibe, dude. But you know, I can't let you get out of here without talking about some Florida shit, man. You want to talk about some crackhead shit real quick? You know, we'll lighten the vibe, cleanse the palate, as it were.
I would love to.
Woo, doggy. Hey, Beatrice.
Yeah?
Get your ass in here. These No Offense boys about to do Welcome to Florida again.
Let me grab the natty.
Oh, shit. And I thought my family was fucked up.
So each and every week, our What the Fuck Florida stories are sponsored by Official Clothing. Living the hip-hop official, the streetwear company, creating high-quality t-shirts, hats, and jewelry at an affordable price, featuring recreations of classic hip-hop logos and sports logos, as well as original designs. There is something at Official for all tastes. Go to official.com, that's O-H-F-I-S-H-L, use code HTNOS, and save 25% off of your order of beautiful, handcrafted t-shirts, hats, and jewelry. Official Clothing.
Live by your own rules.
So this one tickled my fancy, okay? We're kicking it off right down in Key West, where a drunk Florida man was arrested after he was caught operating a stolen floating tiki bar.
Awesome.
Have you ever seen such a thing?
I have not, but I'm assuming that it would be a floating drinking establishment, or maybe possibly like a bar.
Maybe a pontoon or something?
Well, it's very small. It kind of looks like an octagon. It looks like UFC octagon, for maybe even a little bit smaller. And it's just fucking straight up tiki bar, dude. And it's got bar stools on it. You probably dock and then you go out and you drink. It says agents from the Coast Guard Key West station found the man on a stolen tiki hut near Hawks Channel off the coast of the Florida Keys. Don't drink in boat, they tweeted. The man appeared intoxicated. Good was taken one. Into custody by officers from the Florida. He let the Fish and Wildlife fucking take him down. Jesus Christ.
Did the man appear intoxicated? The guy that you caught on a stolen tiki bar?
Maybe. That's really, I'm going to get a picture for you just so you can see it, but that's really all that they said about it. But then they went on to tell you, for reference, there is a company out of New Hampshire of all places named Tiki Hut Boats of New Hampshire that will build you a custom tiki boat bar for $34,000.
That seems like a fucking steal, dude.
No, I'm ready to write a check today.
That's because we spent over 40 G's on your truck. That's fucking expensive.
That's what I'm saying in comparison.
I'd rather get a pontoon for $12,000 and turn it into a fucking bar.
Look, it says it's called the Sunsetter. It says the Sunsetter is delivered with 30 horsepower Suzuki motors, 8 bar stools, a fuel tank, and meets all Coast Guard requirements. It's a ready to sail bar boat. And there's another company called Cruisin' Tikis that they build them and they franchise it to you, so you can take them out and have them, you know, be like your fucking spot.
Can you sleep in / on them?
I would assume so. Yeah, right. I mean, but you know what? That would be fucking terrifying.
Like a round thing with chairs, like just a cool thing with the engines. Like, I don't know if there's like a quarter somewhere you can take a nap. I might be all for this. It'd be like a little houseboat. But if it's just like literally a floating barge with like cool shit attached to it, no. Like, that's, I'm not keeping all my asshole friends around for that. Like, you're going to pay if you want to come hang out on the tiki bar boat. Fuck that.
Right, at least buy gas.
Well, dude, it would be terrifying to spend the night on this boat just because it's open air, dude. Like, there's no walls or nothing. It's just like it's a fucking open bar.
Ooh,
see, I don't think I'm imagining exactly how big this thing is properly, because I'm thinking just like a little, like octagonal shaped thing with like I said, a little center bar piece where you can stand there. What's up, dickhead? You know, and you can get to everybody. There's probably 10 or 12 chairs on it.
Yeah, I got
like a floating dance floor, basically.
I got you. Check that out. See, it's it's not
$30,000.
36.
There better be no. Fuck that. There better be a whole basement to that, like a door you can open up to, like a fucking just a whole 2-bedroom fucking sleeping space under there. Because if not, fuck you. Wait, hold on. Look at that.
Which one?
Oh no, that's the inside of something else. I'm gonna mind my fucking business. I don't know. I'd be looking at Google.
But it's like, how do you with that fucked up shape? It's how do you transport it?
This is excellent work for an audio medium. It's basically a floating Gilligan's Island fucking promo shack. Like it's a shanty on a fucking barge. That's not okay.
Make you buy a custom trailer to pull that shit on. Because how are you gonna haul that?
Well,
no. I'm not paying that much money for something I can't take a nap in. That's fuck that.
I was I was looking at it. I'm like, there's not even room for like an air mattress.
Well, $34,000. Let's be
whatever. The 30 fucking much for what it is.
That's for them to do it. Now it says for anyone that's handy or DIY inclined. Another article claims that for about $16,000 you can build your own. Now it's non-powered or $21,000 to build one with a motor. So I mean, if you can do it yourself, fucking 20 G's, man, you got yourself floating bar.
I think you should do it with the bicycle trick, like they do in the little trolleys where you get on there and you pedal, like a paddle boat thing. That might work.
You're burning off your Michelob Ultras as you're pedaling around.
Man, that's just water any damn way.
Yeah. Fuck that. We'd never get more than 80 yards away from the beach.
Right. I mean, yeah, let's be real, dude. Let's be real.
We're going to float back.
So, moving on down to Port Charlotte, a Florida man was arrested after threatening his ex-boss with a twisted tea can and a metal pipe. This twisted tea can thing is like the new now. Like, people are actually running with it.
Smack me. Smack me. Hit me?
Tell me that wasn't the best thing you've seen. Well, I mean, you see a lot of shit. I don't live on the internet like you do, man. Like, you come up with some shit. So, I mean, this might be a bad question, but like, tell me that ain't the best thing you saw in a long time.
Two things. Number one, the jump across the room and like all chicks jumping and trying to like put their butthole on their fucking camera. Yeah, that's pretty awesome. I enjoy the butts awesome. Challenge. Look, there's a few things that are cooler, but I'm saying it's still pretty cool. But yeah, there's a few other things that I like more, to be honest with you, but.
Then the Twisted Tea Can? Twisted Tea Can was great, dude. And then the remixes, dude. That Dave Matthews Band joint fucking slapped. Come on, man.
Remixes are solid. I hope you put a fucking chunk of one in right here, like just to share the beginning part with the.
So it says Shane Gillis was taken into custody by Charlotte County Sheriff's Office after making multiple threatening calls to his ex-boss. Deputies were called to the scene and overheard Gillis announce he was on his way and he, quote, had something for the victim. I'm going to end you right now. I'm coming straight through the parking lot, he said, according to police. Gillis arrived at the scene and approached the victim carrying a can of twisted tea in his right hand and holding his left hand behind his back. Deputies told him to raise his hand, and as he complied, he told them he had a metal pipe stuck in the back of his pants. So the twisted tea was actually a decoy. He was going to come with the tea and then fucking reach back and clock him with the pipe. It says he continued to verbally threaten his victim even while deputies arrested him. They didn't say where the event took place, but he was arrested at the Peachland Promenade, a strip mall in Port Charlotte. It does sound like a strip club.
Booty club.
According to the complex, Gillis worked at Mr. Mobile RV Repair. So he had some beef with Mr. Mobile's. Have you ever tried to fight a boss, Joey?
No, I've thought about it. Like, anytime you think get wound up enough to want to fight your fucking boss, typically the day you decide to do it, like, it doesn't go the way you plan. It just lets all the air right out of your sail. You're just like, I wanted him at least to fucking say something so I could call him a cocksucker and maybe I could punch him in his face. But never it never happens the way you want.
Well, once I secure this bag tonight with this fucking $1 billion goddamn Mega Millions, then we can all do it together, and then we'll make videos of it. How about this? I'll send each and every one of you guys a can of Twisted Tea, and you go and you clock your fucking boss with a Twisted Tea, and we video it, and we become TikTok famous on top of what we're going to do with the goddamn $1 billion.
I like it. Sign me up, bro.
Seems legit.
The creative juices are flowing already,
man. But you need enough money to pay for the lawsuit that they're going to file against
No, we'll make them sign an NDA after they're laying on the floor covered in fucking malt liquor.
All right, bitch, I'll give you $100,000. Shut the fuck up.
No, and then you start doing it like that. Fuck yeah. Here.
No,
it
you
is.
Just hit him with a bag of pennies.
Hit him with a bag of pennies.
I'll do a twisted tea. I like hard seltzer. Like I said, I wouldn't waste that, but a twisted tea's fine. I'll crack a motherfucker in the eye with that.
For fun.
It's so funny that the guy's name was Shane Gillis. Like, you lost me at that. You know, that's the same comedian that got canceled from SNL. Like, he's a comedian.
Refresh my memory. I don't know who we're talking about. Well, actually, I'll Google him. Tell me who he was. He was on SNL.
He was like the first person that got canceled this past year, like during COVID times. It was he's a New York comedian. He's from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
This nerd?
Yes, he's hilarious. He looks like Colin Hanks, but fatter.
A little bit, yeah. He looks like, no, you know who he looks like, dude? He looks like he sees dead people. What's that kid from The Sixth Sense?
Oh, yeah, he does look like that guy.
Osment, a little bit like fat Haley Joel Osment. But
yeah,
so
yeah.
The deal is he has a podcast, and they were doing this shit, doing their thing, kind of like how Dutchie, I guess, got accused of being racist. He was making a joke, and he said something. He was being sarcastic about, like, old white people back in the day. He was like, yeah, just let all the fucking chinks live over there in Chinatown or whatever. That's how Chinatown became a thing. It was like a... And he said neuters and some weird other shit. And so they did a deep dive on him. And he's a edgy comedian. But it was literally the day after he got accepted to be on SNL. And he was like those comics that had built up some steam very quickly. And everybody was like, oh, shit. Like, this is actually a funny guy that's a new breed. You know, one of these fucking new guys. And, dude, they steamrolled him so hard. They dug up every fucking bad thing he's ever said or done in his whole ass life.
So he's like, he's out still? Like, he's out?
No, he's fine. He's actually the vice president of Skanks, of the Legion of Skanks brand. I don't know if you subscribe to any of that, but it's a New York comedy thing with Big J.
I've heard of it, but I haven't heard it.
I know it peripherally, basically just because of you.
Ari Shaffir is the president. Shane Gillis is his vice president.
That's probably okay. Why I've heard of it.
Okay. Well, I know Big J, and I mean, I know who they are. I don't know.
Right. So it's just funny that you said, like, that's a name I haven't heard very many times, and I heard a lot of names in my days, but it's just, it's funny when you said Shane Gillis, I go, that sounds like something Shane Gillis would do. I need a copy of this this article to send to
you. I have your information. I will send it to you. Maybe it's that motherfucker, dude.
Hilarious.
If not, I was going to say, even if it's not him, which, I mean, chances are it's not, you could still send it to him and be like, look, I seen what you did, motherfucker, and maybe get a shout out or something, dude.
Work on it. Work some magic. I know people.
I know you do. So this last one I've had held here for a couple weeks. We skipped our Florida stories the last couple weeks, and this one, it's an old iteration of this story, so there's been new developments now. But I mean, obviously by now we know that a few weeks back some fellas dressed like Vikings stormed the Capitol, correct?
Yes.
The QAnon shaman. Yeah.
Which, by the way, within hours of him like being on camera, you know, Jason Almy got in his DMs trying to get him on Creatures before he got arrested.
100%. They have the same hats. They have matching hats.
They just have Buddha beads too.
I said, dude, I don't even know what I would say to him, but sure, fucking go for it.
Yeah, they're touching
together, look at each other, going like, yeah. Oh yeah, all that.
Nothing creature about him except his headdress.
So, Florida man that stole Nancy Pelosi's lectern. He actually lives about 30 minutes south of here, or lived before he got arrested.
Oh, we had a guy from Arkansas that I guess went in and did some shit in Nancy Pelosi's office or desk or stole something, a letter. I don't know, but it's funny.
Stole the laptop?
No, that was some bitch. That was some girl that they were saying was trying to sell to Russia.
Yeah, no laptop. It was just some stationery, I think. He got in trouble. Like, these fucking idiots, dude, look. Do what you do. You know, I'm not condoning fucking burning shit down. Nope. But if you're mad, be mad, whatever. But
take a fucking shit out of your desk and leave.
Guys, you dumb motherfuckers couldn't put your phone down for 15 minutes. Or looking out for your friends or your buddies, your accomplices now. You couldn't put your phone down for 20 minutes, dude, to not have every FBI agent and their fucking brother sifting through every picture from everybody's phone across the internet to find out where you work to come and arrest you for being a shithead. You're just being a shithead. There's nothing you didn't, except for a couple of people, they broke some shit. But most of those people, they're just shitheads making bad decisions, fucking got all fired up, maybe had one too many day drinking. And we're like, hey, we're going to go down there and put on our fucking Trump stuff, some lady was wearing a flag that said, "Don't tread on me," and she got trampled to death. If that's not the funniest goddamn thing, like,
dude, I mean, not for nothing, it kind of fucking is.
It's ridiculous. Some guy had a heart attack because he zapped himself with his taser. Like,
right. Just a bunch people of clowns. Do
dumb shit.
Hey, you know what? Bless their heart. That's a Southern thing, okay? Let's forego the one-star reviews, okay? I don't condone the shit either. That's just a Southern way of speaking.
Motherfuckers are touched.
Well, dude, they rolled on this guy real quick, too, man. It says, well, I'll skip to the end. Soon after Johnson's, the guy's name is fucking something Johnson. Soon after Johnson's photo went viral, local residents were quick to identify him. They told the outlet that the rioter was a dad of five who lives in the Gulf Coast town of Parrish with his wife, who is licensed to be a family medicine doctor. What are the chances she's getting fucking disbarred, too?
Yeah, she's not going to have much work now.
Wait, that's lawyers. Lawyers is bar, right?
Doctors take an exam, a bar exam too.
Do they? I don't know.
They're licensed. They're notorious. It's going to be a little bit harder to get a job when there's people standing out in front of your building with signs.
Right. Well, she was a doctor, and even before this, it said he had a long list of run-ins with the law, including numerous marijuana arrests and a felony possession of cocaine. So, I mean, she was still practicing while he was, like, fucking getting busted.
I bet you dad was so happy that she picked him to spend the life with.
Probably, dude. You'd be a doctor and shit, and then your husband's going down on fucking coke charges and shit.
Felony cocaine could be a few different things, though. Like, I'm not defending the man. I'm just saying to get felony cocaine, hopefully he just had a kit on him. Like, paraphernalia plus cocaine can equal a felony charge, unless it's crack. Crack will get you a felony. But cocaine, you just have a bag of coke, like, you'll probably be okay as long as it's just for you. Unless you have a half a pound of coke, then that's a problem.
That's an issue.
Jodie, have you ever done coke?
Yeah, a lot once.
A lot once?
I love how big your eyes got, dude. A lot once.
There was a point in my life where I dabbled a little. It was right before I got arrested, as a matter of fact.
Yeah.
That's not right before, a few months before. But yeah, we had about a couple months. We just did a lot of it and spent a lot of money. And I was like, this is awesome and all, but I can't afford this. And then I started like bumming it off my weed dealer. And she was a big fat chick. And I would have sex with her for coke. And it was just... It was a rough time of my life.
Well, you didn't suck any dicks, so I feel like that's all right.
I wasn't sucking dicks. I was just fucking big, just big fucking chicks. And you know what? She was sweet. I'm not mad at her. I'm just saying, like,
do a sit-up, you know, bitch.
Is an Arkansas big bigger than a regular big?
Chris, I'm 6 foot, 220. I've been about this size, maybe a little skin, like lighter. Never more than like 190 ever. 185 when I got shot. That's the lowest, but I lost a lot of weight.
Just in the face, right? Just in the face.
Yes. Well, I couldn't eat because my jaw was all jacked up. So
I tried. I'm sorry. I fumbled it.
No, but you're fine. That's the thing. My caloric intake dropped substantially for a few days. And turns out if you really want to lose weight, just eat through your goddamn nose for like 4 days.
Oh,
that'll take it off you.
No. I would try it. I've tried everything else.
Heck yeah, just put a tube up your nose and out your asshole and just let it rip, dude. You'll be fine.
Magnet patches, diet pills.
Dude, I'm going to come out tomorrow Hollywood and she's going to be shakes. Trying to fucking snort a line of scrambled eggs and shit off the fucking counter tomorrow. I'm like, Jodie said I'll lose weight if I eat it through my nose.
It's fine.
It's all fun. No, man,
I mean, it's fun. That's the problem with cocaine. It's fun and it's expensive, so you don't fuck with it.
I literally was telling somebody like this week that I was like, that's the main reason like I've never tried coke is because I'm so deathly afraid that I'm gonna love it and I can't afford to love it. Like, it sounds really fucking awesome. I think I'd get a lot of shit done.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know if you get a lot of shit done. You probably talk Dutch's ear off. You guys would start like a snow cone stand or something. What do you think, Dutch? You got a small business idea? Anything you've been looking to get into?
I could do snow cones.
Dude. I love a snow cone stand. I think it's great. Like 10 grand, you just go sit around. I've been working in the heat the summertime for probably the last 15 years, man. He told me I could just sit in a box and sling $3 fucking cups of ice at little kids and shit all day, man.
Yeah.
Put me in that box. I wish you would. I got Netflix. I got air conditioning. I'll fucking sit in here all day.
It's so funny you chose that of all things, too, because like we were out last weekend for her birthday and we were coming home and we drove down to Sarasota, so it's about a good hour ride from here. And we were coming home and we got all the way back to our exit off the interstate and the little guy had to go to the bathroom. I'm like, we'll be home in 5 minutes. Can you wait? No, I can't wait. Get off the interstate, pull in the first gas station that we see, and they're taking fucking forever. So I was like, damn, he probably had to drop a two. Fucking, they come back and she's got a whole like McDonald's like carry out tray full of styrofoam cups from the gas station and shit. And I was like, "What you got?" And she was like, "Snow cones." And they got a fucking snow cone station in the goddamn.
It's called Snowballs.
That's great.
Of course it is, dude. Of course.
Yeah, touch.
It was good too because they have like one of those really cool shavers where it shaves everything in the cup and then you kind of like put it up there to like make it mold.
So it's like on demand snow cones.
Yeah, and you take a spoon, you put it in the middle, he dumps the liquid shit in there, and then he dumps it in the middle and he kind of puts them on top. It's really good.
I think a snowball. I could be wrong. I think that's like the Louisiana version, like the New Orleans version of a snow cone. They call it different shit from wherever
shaved,
you're at.
It's like shaved ice. It's not like those. Remember those rainbow snow cones we had when we were kids? They were hard as shit. You break your teeth on them.
Hell yeah.
Builds character.
Drink that nasty juice that was all purple or brown because it all ran together.
Ooh. Fucking paper cup would just fall apart halfway through, and you'd be squeezing that shit.
Y'all are nasty, dude.
All that shit.
I think Arkansas and Indiana are very similar.
Probably. We both got hillbillies.
Yeah, y'all got fucking connections. I see it right now.
Snow cone
the two
connections.
Of you. Jody, I'm not going to hold you up all night, and my lovely wife has to work in the morning, so I say we put a bow on this, but I'm glad you came by. I'm glad you came by to do your annual visit with us. Hopefully, we can do maybe a semi-annual this year, because I know I had Podcast at a Roundtable Season 2 on my list of bullet points, and we didn't get there tonight, so maybe when all that shit starts again, maybe we can fucking have you back and talk about some of the bullshit that's going down with that.
No, I told you, no drama, no shenanigans. See that? Now, we got all the way past that, no problem.
Perfect. But not no promises for next time.
Yeah, I can't make that promise, guys. Thanks for having me. And, you know, you could have been anywhere in the world. Thanks for letting me hang out in your clubhouse. It's been a minute, and I'll try to come see you sooner.
Fuck yeah, man. Where can the folks find you on the internet?
You can Google search Poboys Podcast. You can at Twitter, at Poboy Pod. Also, go to biobidet.com. Use promo code Poboys. Yeah. Receive 10% off. You get yourself a bidet, you clean your asshole like a champion.
We call that wetting the whistle.
Woo! Change your life.
But also, well, I guess they do whistle.
Yeah, it's a little whistle. Keep that whistle clean.
It's a dirt whistle.
It's a dirty whistle. And we are the motherfucking hashtag No Offense Show. I am the real Wutzky. This young lady is the Duchess Wutzky. Collectively, you can find us at htnos.com, htnos on all the socials. Give us a follow. Give us a subscribe, if you will, if you like what you heard. If this is your first time, thanks for stopping by and checking us out. We're also part of a little network of shows called the Inner Circle Podcast Network. Go to innercirclepn.com for the whole roster. I'm talking about Simmons and More, Shit Happens When You Party Naked, The Hood Diner, The Plunge, Failing Hollywood, as well as Creatures of the Night. We get weird, and we have a good time, all of us, collectively and individually. What am I forgetting? Fuck you, Kyle?
Yeah, always.
Fuck you, Kyle.
Yeah, fuck you, Kyle, you motherfucker. Keep your bitch to yourself and suck a fat dick from the back.
He was the one that left the review.
Maybe he was. I don't fucking know.
You know damn well it's your cousin. Tell cousin Kyle to shut the fuck up. He's not bugging you on the internet. Probably.
You know what, Jody? I had a conspiracy theory that Kyle was Joe B, and I forgot to bring it up to him when he was on the podcast, because Joe B is the kind of motherfucker that would do some shit under a fake name. And then when I called him out on it, he was like, why would you think that'd be me? I would never do that. Like, whatever, dude. Yes, you fucking would, yes, too.
Good, I'll piss me. I know you're bored. Shut up. You've been in the house as long as we have.
Right.
Getting line to the left, line to the right. Both lines in, and you sucking a fuck. Right, Jody?
You can go suck a whole fuck. You can be on one end. You can be on the other. You guys can come together in the middle, suck a whole fuck. Guys, thank you so much, for real. And, yeah, man, it's been a pleasure getting to hang out with y'all. And
same.
You know? Keep me posted what you guys are doing. Anything new? If I could be a service, you guys want me to come hang out? I'll clean your pool. I don't know.
Yeah, come on, man.
We have a pool guy.
We thought that we're coming up on the. I mean, Super Bowl's 2 weeks away, and that was supposed to be the fucking meetup, and now that's not happening. I don't think nobody.
Maybe next year, man. Like, you know, everybody, I think, is going to reevaluate how much they've going around and seeing people they love and want to hang out with.
Well, Jody B, next year the fucking Super Bowl isn't going to be 15 minutes away from my house.
True.
Like, it's legit in town this year. It was, the stars were aligning and fucking COVID took a dump on it.
I wonder what that's going to be like, because you know WrestleMania was way different this year. I wonder what the Super Bowl is going to be like in COVID time.
I don't know. We last time it was here, her and I went down there. She was pregnant with, so we didn't have any kids. She was.
I wasn't pregnant.
I thought you were with child at the time.
No, she was just with kids. She had them in a fucking.
No, I don't.
She had me.
Satchel. That was 2005, right?
No. It was like 8 or 9.
I wasn't pregnant, or I was like really just pregnant.
Well, she, like you said, if she was with child, that means she could have just been with you.
That's true too.
It was
fun.
It was fun. So I hope to do it again. I hope they have a little bit of the same shit, but they might
do everything and just tell people to wear masks because that's what everybody else is fucking doing.
It is Florida. We are loosey goosey.
Mm-hmm.
But well, y'all be careful. Dutch is fucking done. Go, Dutch. Have a good evening. We'll get you some mascara. You gotta work.
I like seeing your face the whole time. Normally, you're just like, you know, a silhouette on the screen. So thanks for hardwiring your computer for us.
I was gonna say that. Like, I thought about it today. I go, you know, since I only come on like once a year, I got this computer last year after I talked to y'all. So yeah, y'all don't have even seen all this new setup with the Force Ghost and the fucking full video. It's been fun.
Normally, it's like, hey guys, all right, and turn it off.
See, I didn't even think, this is our first show with you in the new house, too. So, like, with the backdrop and the light and all this fucking shit, I mean, like, we try to look a little professional for you now, man. It's not my dining room anymore.
That's true.
It's nice, man. We're semi-professional podcasters. Isn't there that beautiful?
Go. Yeah.
Wonderful stuff.
Who'd have fucking thunk it? Guys, I love you. I'm going to go talk to my wife and maybe feed her food.
All right, brother. We'll holler at you.
Later, all Jody. Right,
buddy.
Jody, have you ever done coke?
Yeah, a lot, once.